Look at that in and away. Uses her speed to get on the outside and a right-hand pen. But look at that footwork. The head fake goes through two defenders. And her running style is so smooth.
Russell. Not tackled there. Harvey got the offload. Great little angle for Canada now. Oh, just a breakaway try here for Hannah Darling. And Hannah Darling in under the post for Canada's second try. Ball pops out the side. Picked up by Canada now. Canada.
Off the foot, off the foot.
They're going to have to go from their own 10-yard line, but it's New Zealand with turnover ball. Is the game going to be won in this moment? Woodman, it is. Portia Woodman in under the post. And Portia Woodman, her fifth try already on day one here in Clermont-Ferrand. Alice Richardson decides to go for the switch to Scarlett. Fisher takes the line, look at that! And the strength of Heather Fisher, she is on fire!
They have options both left and right. They go to the right-hand side where they have the numbers. Nice defense though, again, scramble from Marcendet. And Spain, well, they'll finish this game with their seventh try. Up nice and high by Layla of Calta. Retained by the Spanish team. What can they do with it? A little bit of space on the outside, but the long loping strides. Oh, what a try by the forward. How good's that? It's a wobbly old kick there, but easily taken by Scarrett, the captain, who gets it out. England with great go forward there. She just goes through the hole. And the step as well. Claire Allen, nice offload as well. And here's a reply and a double for Kay Wilson.
Kelly Griffin. Ball bounces here into Victoria Falayan. Falayan, she is strong. And if she can get away, she can cause problems. Backs herself. Victoria Falayan. That's why she's on the wing for the United States team. And for once, we've seen the outstanding pace of Victoria Falayan. 63rd try on the Sevens World Series.
Second.
Shannon Parry was sharp there. Good hands. Oh, lovely little hands in the centre. Cherry takes off. Got Tanigato on the outside. It's a 1-2 for Tanigato, and it's her 50th try on the Women's Seven Series. The press defence is good from France, and look, once again, just stretching this Irish defence. Step and go. Brilliant, brilliant play by Caroline Ladanou.
Quick recycle too, and they've got a bit of space on the outside. If Fiji can move it, they decide to take it back in. Does Thumu. Bouncing ball, look at the numbers for France there. Four in and around that one ball, nice. Offload, and she's in the open. Is yep. Luisa Bassetti-Solo. And she will score her the second try for Fiji, puts it down there.
Rock.
You can't hear him, the Duff tries to protect ball over the top. Well, ball shot out.
Hello.
And the beneficiary is Australia's Nicole Beck. Nicole Beck gets the support. Dalton plays football with it.
Release now.
Tremendous cover came in from Fanny Orta. But it's Australia with numbers up here. It's just a simple pass on the wide outside. And Shannon Parry scores for Australia.
So that was the best of the action in the pool stages on day one in Claremont, which meant the quarterfinals looked a little bit something like this. England against the United States. New Zealand took on the host nation, France. Australia against Spain, and then Canada against Fiji. Some cracking games. Here's the action.
And here's McLean, who started the movement by ripping ball from the United States. And then Emily Scarrett, she sets off on one of those mazy runs, and Scarrett, just the power. But you knew the minute she got the ball that Emily Scarrett was going to back herself. This will be her 20th try on the Sevens World Series.
Fata Simpkins again. Williams pass on the ground from her. McAllister trying to get the offload to Woodman, and away she goes. Push a woman on the outside. Burn and turn, and away she goes. Try number six in Claremont. What a stunning score by Portia Woodman.
Wait, wait.
Possession key for France now. Fanny Orta, show and go from her. Fata Simpkins after her. Drags it to the ground, good support as well. Trying to get through the tackle, and she goes, Grassino! Foot race for the corner! Grassino is going to get there! What a try by the little French terrier!
And just confirmation there, if Australia win this match, they are the series
Captain Blue.
Champions. Dalton has Cherry on the outside, and then Green. It's quite a formidable option. But look at Emily Cherry. Oh, is that not one of the best tries we've seen? Emily Cherry, take a bow.
Play on.
Panatani. Pilates cuts back again. She's done an awful lot of that, switching the play, looking at the angles. Caslick probing the blind side once again. And Charlotte Caslick with a classy try there. Classic Caslick. And confirmation that Australia are the series champions.
So Fiji against Canada for the last remaining semi-final place in the cup.
Rack! Rack!
Paquin.
New advantage.
Russell again. Ferrella. Nice hands to Landry. Landry shows up and goes for the line. Is she down? Yes, she is. Second try for Ghislaine Landry, and Canada in the driving seat. Rewind once more. Off the deck. Naya Basali. Numbers out wide. Surely the pass has to go. Naya Basali's going to back herself. Needs support and gets it. Satala's going to score for Fiji. Yeah, but it wasn't enough though. Canada advancing to the semi-finals. They play England champions in Langford, while we had near neighbours, great enemies on the Seven Series. New Zealand against Australia in a second semi-final. Here is what went down.
Enticing and pulling Canadian defenders onto her as Claire Allen. Out on the wide outside, Jap is Kay Wilson, and Wilson goes for the corner. Brilliant pace by Kay Wilson.
Advantage over.
And coming away is the Canadian skipper. In out, Ghislaine Landry. Canada have got a magician, and that is Ghislaine Landry. So the throw in the line out is taken by Paquin. The wraparound movement. Here's Landry. Look at the quick feet from Landry. That was magnificent. And Landry, is she going to go the distance? This is the hat-trick time for Ghislaine Landry. What a match she has played against England. Fantastic from Landry.
Oh.
Rasavengi has a look and happy to let play continue. Australia turn defence into attack in a matter of seconds. Dalton with the pass. Oh, brilliant to Emily Cherry. She's not going to be caught. Emily Cherry, Sarah Goss giving chase. She's almost at her. Emily Cherry's going to turn on the gas to make sure she gets there, and she only just does. What a try. Tired bodies. KT, what about that?
Goss to Woodman. Woodman against Elia Green. And Nicole Beck, she's got two to beat Portia Woodman. She's gone. She is gone. Portia Woodman, they will not catch her from there. Even Elia Green, the speed machine, can't stop her.
So Australia again coming out on top against New Zealand in the semi-final. So a look ahead to what's to come. We do have the bowl final, Russia against Ireland, coming up in a few minutes' time. Plate final looks like this, United States of America against the host nation, France. So the cup as well, the main prize on offer here in Clermont-Ferrand. Canada against Australia. Australia already confirmed the series champions. I'm sure it will want to finish with a flourish and take the title here in Clermont-Ferrand. But it is the bowl final first, and it's Russia against Ireland. Well, they've played twice, and Russia have won on both occasions. Last minute Atlanta, 10-7, only 3 points in it on that occasion. And this is how the starting seven look for either team. Minislamova, the captain from Russia, taking over the captain's armband for Clermont-Ferrand. And a relatively new-look squad chosen by Pavel Barnovsky for this game. Ireland, Lucy Mulhall, the captain aside. So the bowl final sees Russia take on Ireland, and a little spattering of rain coming down in Clermont. Hopefully it won't affect the conditions too much. In fact, the majority of the day has been dry and perfect evening for a game of sevens rugby. Pavel Barnovsky, we know how animated he gets. Anthony Eddy is canvas personified for Ireland, and it'll be interesting to see how this one goes. Maggie Alfonsi is beside me. Yeah, yep. I suppose Ireland, with that victory over Japan, will fancy their chances here.
Most definitely. Ireland will have that confidence after the way they played against Japan, but Russia, their power and the pace, are going to want to stop that.
Different styles of play, and we have 14 minutes to decide our bowl winners as Lucy Mulhall gets us underway. Audrey O'Flynn off to chase after that one. Ashley Baxter makes the tackle in on Minislamova, the captain, and first touch for Lushina, one of the key playmakers this weekend for Russia. Nice pass on the outside to Shemchuk. Couldn't get into the starting seven at all, really, in Langford and in Atlanta, but obviously Barnovsky changing things up and keeping the squad on their toes here in Clermont, with that Olympic qualifier, of course, still to come. And this is a big marker for Korobchuk. Keeps it alive. Hands to Ledovskaya. And ball at the back for Korobchuk to try and go again. Good save. He's got Lushina outside. Good save. It runs across. Megan Williams makes the tackle. And again, back up to make two in a row. Brilliant work by Megan Williams in defence for Ireland. Little dummy around the fringe. Baxter makes the tackle. That one just about held on to preventing the knock on there. Hands from Minislamova. Looks for the inside runner. Audrey O'Flynn tries to drag her towards the touchline. Misses her first time, but Baxter comes in to make it on the second count. Ledovskaya at scrum half. Pop pass up to Gutseva. Again, no way through the Irish defence, which has been rock solid today. No tries conceded. O'Flynn on her feet in the wrong position. It's offside. And the penalty will be to Russia.
Great retention by Russia, but the physicality here by Ireland to create that knock-on, but unfortunately she was offside.
Lushina tackled by Doyle.
Rock!
And they work the left-hand side, the blind side. Korobchuk, no room for her. Nice offload to keep it alive. Bob Cove on the outside. And the pass to Lushina. Tree tries to skip through
Ireland defence being tested here inside their own 22. Room out wide here if the Russians want to move it. Kutseva on the straight line, it was forward. You could see what Kutseva was trying to do. The pass was forward.
Oh, it was a beautiful line there by Kutseva. One thing which Russia are trying to do is trying to cut the angle. They're seeing that Ireland are over chasing, and it's just a beautiful line. But the problem is the pass just went forward there by Shimshuk. But cutting that line is going to be key if you want to cut through the Irish defence.
Crouch.
So first time that Ireland will have possession since we kicked off 2.5 minutes ago. Ball squirts out the back. Flood did well to Mulhall. He's got one outsider. And Doyle just outside that 22. Scored in our last match. Opened the scoring for Ireland against Japan. Megan Williams looking for runners outside. Audrey O'Flynn can't onto it. Advantage to Russia.
Advantage.
And they might try and make Ireland pay here.
Advantage over.
Taken up by Korobchuk. She's going to score. Russia's first try eventually comes and it goes to their number 11.
Lovely try there by Korobchuk. All came from the patience of Russia to put pressure on Ireland. Unfortunately there, Megan Williams knocking on and Russia capitalising on that error.
Lushina from in front of the post should add the extra two. She does, just enough. Russia lead by 7 points to nil. 3.5 minutes gone, and well, Ireland having to defend for the majority of the opening spell here.
Yeah, just a lovely reaction there by Russia to get onto the ball and just to attack that space. For Russia, they're just being patient. They're waiting for their opportunity and reacting on any error that happens.
Lushina to restart. And as I mentioned, you know, the Olympic qualifiers coming at the end of June in Dublin. Two of these sides will be competing along with Spain for a place in Rio. Only one place on offer. You have to win that tournament, and this will be a good test or a barometer at least for how far Ireland have come. Here is Doyle. Scott, Amy Lee Murphy Crowe outside, who can't hang on to that ball. It's another knock on and another advantage to Russia. Here's the try score for Russia. Korobchuk with the pass on the outside to Minislamova. Lushina, direct running from Bobkova. Show and go, Bobkova through the gap, inside the 22. Ireland desperate defending at the moment, kept alive. Shemchuk, Lushina wants the switch, tackled hard. A little step on the outside from Kutseva. And Russia in for try number two. It's all too easy for them.
Oh, well worked try there by Russia. Kutseva, she just saw the space out wide. She dazzled the Irish defence with her footwork and got around. It's a lovely bit of play. She gets the ball, she spots the space out wide, she takes two out. And what a skill to do so. To commit the defence and to hit the opportunity with the space out wide.
5 seconds.
Lushina. Conversion goes right and wide. 90 seconds left to play at the end of the first half, and Russia in control here.
Yeah, here what we saw is that Ireland just cut it in a bit too soon. Have to be patient when you're that close to your try line. But that ability to hold back and be patient and be disciplined is very hard to do. And unfortunately there, Ireland let Russia in.
Baxter trying to stay in field. Russian defence attempting to drag her into touch there for Lucy Mulhall to try and get something going here. They do have plenty of options on the bench, the likes of Alison Miller and Selin Upu, who we haven't seen so far today. Just she had a lot of bumps and bruises from yesterday and mightn't be okay to come on. She is named as a substitute, but interesting to see what changes they make in the second half. Mulhall hits the ground there again for Stacey Flood to Megan Williams. Audrey O'Flynn using her strength into contact. No scrum half there at the moment for Ireland, so it's messy ball back for Ashley Baxter. And Minislamova makes the tackle and forces turnover. Lushina, no time to catch her breath. 20 seconds to go. Little dummy in the pass in the out wide. It's one-on-one here for Russia. And Bobkova, well marshalled by Mulhall. Acting scrum half is Kutseva. Lushina once more. Minislamova.
Skaya hits the deck, and there is the halftime hooter. Next time it goes dead, we'll have the break. Still some rugby to be played, though. Good saver.
Rack.
Ireland having to defend. Be a mismatch here if Lushina can spot it. She steps off her inside and still going, Lushina. Over to 22.
It's been all Russia at the moment. Just going to keep the hands on the ball.
Yeah, they're going to try and go around the outside. That's exactly what they do. Well, good save is in again. And Russia shot down for the third try, and Ireland look very tired at the moment.
Yeah, a lot of tired legs out there from Ireland. And for Russia, again, that patience. They just let the ball do the work. And you can see the aggression, the commitment on her face there. No, very well worked try there by Russia. What have Ireland got left in the tank to take into second half?
So conversion. Splits the post from Lushina. There is the halftime whistle. Russia firmly in control. 3-0. Ireland yet to score. And it's the Russians who lead by 19-0.
Уходи куда-то. Тебя не могут выдавить 10 метров назад. Они бегут тебя отрабатывать, а ты 10 метров с мячом назад давишь. Дальше, Юль, стой на ногах. Вот даже сейчас, в последний момент, ты же специально падаешь. Ну, прорвалась, приз, и стой, смотри, кому подкинуть. Ты же последнего игрока вошла. Зачем вы падаете на землю? Вы же сейчас выиграете только из-за того, что вы их заставляете бегать слева-право, слева-право. Посмотрите, что плохо. Вы опять ни разу не сыграли. У вас из рака мяч выходит, вы все стоите в глубине. А кто рядом будет играть? Вот сейчас, смотрите, вы выиграете 3 попытки. Тяжело? Тогда будьте любезны, не отдавать мяч. Отдадите мяч, заколебетесь бегать в защите. Будете держать мяч, все время контролировать. Только еще раз говорю, не падайте вы, все получится. Дальше, выиграли мяч, пожалуйста, медленнее. Если нужно, отдыхать, пожалуйста, перед схваткой, перед коридором отдыхать. Я вам сейчас левым зрокову скоро выпущу.
Давай, давай, давай! Давай, давай!
Давай! So you've got to dominate possession as well. For this half, girls, when we haven't got the ball, we go looking for it and get it back as hard as quickly as we possibly can. So to do that, we've got to be aggressive around our defence. When we have got it, we control it and we force them to defend and defend and defend. Okay? Let's go.
Come on, girls. Come on. Let's keep that ball now.
Contrast in styles, I think it's fair to say, between the two coaches.
Yeah, I mean, Anthony Eddy, very calm, very relaxed. And then Baranowski, well,
I mean, if you didn't see the first half, Maggie, and I said, tell me which coach is 19-0 down and which one is 19-0 up, you might confuse the two, right?
Yeah, I probably would have said Anthony Eddy there. But, I mean, look, Anthony Eddy, you know, the good thing about him, he's very composed. But the thing now is all about trying to make sure they dominate possession, as what he said before at halftime.
Yeah, well, they need that ball, don't they? 3 tries down. That one bounces just on the 10-metre line, and Ashley Baxter couldn't hold on to it. It's another knock-on. That's another mistake from Ireland, and it's just, you feel, not their day. Certainly they're impressive against the Japanese, but they haven't shown up so far.
No. Look, Antonelli said dominate possession, keep the ball when you get it, and their knock-on hasn't helped their cause.
Crouch, bind, set.
Scrum for Russia, Lushina with the feed. And Shemshuk trying to get something going through the middle, almost got away from the tackle. There for Minislamova. Lushina once more. Trying to go around the outside is Bobkova. Good tackle though. From Amy Lee Murphy Crow. Had the pace to get there. Here's Doyle. Murphy Crow again. Can hold on to the ball. It went backwards though. Play on, says the referee. Russia have stolen possession again. Irish mistakes killing them at the moment. And the Russians looking to take advantage. Lushina. Space on this near side here. It'll show and go. Ledovskaya calling for her, but here is Lushina. Needs a bit of help, does she? Back inside. Ledovskaya has to let go, surely. Good work from Ashley Baxter.
Great work there by Ireland, their patience. They saw the running support lines by Russia. Lovely tackle there by Stacey Flood, and then the quick reaction by Ashley Baxter to get over. and make the turnover. But look at the tackling of Russia, the aggression. You think they're tired, but do you know what? They've still got that energy to keep going.
Megan Williams and Eva Doyle take a break. In comes Alison Miller, who got a try with her first touch of the ball against Japan as Ireland go up the line and take the line out here, looking for a possession off the top. So Flynn is going to be the target. Good take from her. Gets a bit of a knock as well. Flood. Mulhall to Miller. Flood again. That one looked like it went forward from here. Advantage being played to Russia. None coming. Another mistake from Ireland.
Yeah, look. It's all about keeping the ball. And look, we know they're tired. The final game for them. They've got 4 minutes, 4.5 minutes to go. But again, it's that clinical accuracy and making sure you get the ball to hand, especially when you're tired, because the last thing you want to do is turn the ball over again and have to defend, because it's very tiring defending.
Bind, set.
Lushina tackled without the ball there. Ireland give away the penalty. Quick tap and go from the Russian number two. Options out wide here, and one of them is the speedster, Zadrakova, trying to burn Alison Miller on the outside. Not going to happen on that occasion. And Mulhall comes in to make the tackle. There again for Russia at the base. Gutseva picks straight into Alison Miller.
Now release,
trying to keep it alive. Lushina. Minislamova. Nice hands from the Russians to keep it alive. Bobkova. Well, just as I say, they dropped the ball. Did it go forward? It did. And Ireland will get possession in their own 22.
Something that Baranowski was highlighting at halftime was to make sure they get the ball wide. And you can see Russia trying to force the ball wide, but unfortunately, we're unable to take the ball when it was given to them. But they're trying to cut the angle as well. They're trying to stretch Ireland, because Ireland are tired now. They can stretch them and create those gaps. Then they can cut those lovely lines.
Bind. Set.
Hannah Tyrrell comes in for Ireland. Pass evades her, but Alison Miller there to clean it up. Tries the handoff. Kick and chase now. Kim Flood after this one. Zadrakova's back there, and she might fancy a go here. That's exactly what she tries. Zadrakova tackled by Mulhall. Into support and clear out, but they give away a penalty, not releasing on the ground. And Kim Flood to Mulhall, and they get on with it quickly. Tyrrell to Miller. Alison Miller trying to go through. Ali Miller, lovely run from Alison Miller. Stretches the legs over the 22. Does she need help? Brilliant cover tackle by Minislova. Captain's effort there. Ball at the back. Baxter to Tyrrell. Surely Audrey O'Flynn has got to win in the corner. O'Flynn for Ireland. And Audrey O'Flynn scores Ireland's first try.
Ireland finally on the scoreboard. And what a way to do it. You almost think you probably could have scored a little bit sooner. They're giving the pass to Amy Lee Murphy-Crow. But great patience to keep the ball and get it out wide.
Well, here we see it again. It was all made by Alison Miller's break. Brilliant strong running from her, and eventually the ball went wide. Super cover tackle by Minislamova, but Audrey O'Flynn, lovely pass from Tyrrell.
Yeah, you almost think a little bit when Alison Miller made that break that she should have given that pass on the left-hand side to Amy Lee Murphy-Crow, but Ireland were very smart to recycle the ball.
High, hanging restart. Oh, Mulhall, brilliant kick from her. And it's forced the advantage for Ireland now. Alison Miller trying to go on the outside again. Strong legs to kick clear. Whistle goes and penalty against Ireland for not releasing on the ground.
Alison Miller tried to get around, but great determination and commitment there by Ellen Drakova. But Ireland there just needed to release the ball.
And Russia up to go up the touchline. Ireland need two tries at the very least just to draw level. And looks like a big ask now with less than a minute to play.
Especially when you've got a minute left like this, your legs are tired, your lungs are knackered. But you still want to finish on a high, especially if you're Russia right now.
Slap back towards Lushina. Pass from her to Shemshuk. And off goes, good save. Huh? Chance to stretch the legs now, Zdrakova. Has to step back inside. Good tackle again, sweeping across there. Lucy Mulhall, Lushina. Well, was that crossing or not? Referee says no play on. Irish appeal for the decision, but didn't get it. Russia again, keep it alive. Gavrilyuk. Back inside to Gutseva. Zdrakova. There's the hooter. So next time this ball goes dead, that'll be that. Shemshuk. Tackled and tackled well by Hannah Tyrrell. Zdrakova. Lushina. Pass on the outside. Noritsina. Noritsina stretches the legs. And they're going to finish with a bang here, Russia. Jotting down in the corner. That will seal it. Russia will win the bowl. And Pavel Barnovsky, well, maybe he's smiling on the inside.
Oh, a big smile, definitely on the inside, but great work there by Russia. You see the ball just comes out wide and she just backs herself. She gains a bit of time. Latina, just to get outside, Ashley Baxter. With the pass, just inviting her into that space.
Well, Noratina finishes it off. Lushina to try and add the extra conversion, doesn't matter. And that one, not one of her better ones. The final whistle goes and Russia, well, it's been a convincing victory here in the bowl final. And interesting in terms of the permutations, perhaps, of what's to come on the Olympic qualifier in Dublin at the end of June. Russia, convincing winners against Ireland, who will feel like they did not do themselves justice there. Certainly room for improvement, and they will know that. But this one is for Russia. It's been a mixed season for them, you have to say. After doing so well last year and in Dubai as well, reaching the final. Since then, they just have fallen away and it hasn't been at the standard we would expect. But they'll take the ball here in Clermont-Ferrand. For Ireland now, I suppose the attention's turned towards that Olympic qualifier. They do have a tournament in Russia next week to prepare for. And some players to come back into the fold. I'm thinking of Louise Galvin as well, who's at home. Almost over that broken leg, but Russia, winners of the bowl, just too strong over the last 14 minutes.
Yeah, really impressive play by Russia to end the day. And I mean, they're still without key players like Kudanova, Hamadova. But for both Russia and Ireland, the priority is the repertoire in June.
So Russia bowl winners. And as you mentioned, even with the players that are missing from the squad, chance to blood some new young talent, including the try scorer there at the very end, Noritsina. And they look pretty content with their weekend's work. So we'll have the presentation. And it goes to the Russian captain, their number one, Anna Minislamova. With Kudanova absent, of course. Russia, bowl champions in Clermont-Ferrand 2016.
Thank you. Mais une nouvelle fois, l'équipe de Russie pour cette victoire et ce trophée. On rappelle que dans quelques minutes maintenant, nous allons assister à un moment Fidji-Espagne.
Oui, pour le match pour la 16e place, avant que nous ayons donc cette finale, juste après la finale qui nous intéresse, face aux États-Unis d'Amérique. Mais ils sont encore là.
My name is Anna Maria Rongida. I'm Fiji Sevens captain, and this is my 7 in 60. My friend just called me Anna. Short name from Anna Maria, Anna. I miss my family a lot, because I always love them being there for me, supporting and cheering for me. Litia Nengato, we always call her Arnold, the tall one, yeah. I won't answer that because... Coaching, I have to do coaching after I leave rugby. Zen Bolt, Ian Thop, and the netball is the shooter one. That will be my dream come true, so I celebrate with my friends and family.
A lovely little insight there to Anna Maria Rongitha, who will be playing in the next match coming up here. It will see Fiji against Spain in the Stade Gabriel Montpellier. Great setting. And Fiji will take on Spain, the 7th-8th playoff game. Well, Fiji had 2 wins on day one. They lead 5-1 in the series. Last met in Langford when Fiji won by 15 points to 10. A misconversion, incidentally, for Fiji cost them a place in that quarter-final in Langford. But I must say, it's been a much improved performance here by this Fijian team. A couple of players who have really caught the eye are Kumu, Marawa Kumu, rampaging forward, and the flying winger, Luisa Tusalo, wearing the number 12 jersey. The side is captained by Anna Maria Rongitha. Spain will want to finish this tournament on a high in Patricia Garcia, wearing the number 4 jersey. They have a playmaker who would slot into any of the other teams on the women's series. Casado is back to her best, and the side is captained by Elizabeth Martinez, wearing the number 6 jersey. Well, the crowd have stuck around here. We're into the last few games. The USA will play France coming up, England, New Zealand in the 3rd-4th playoff, and then Canada versus Australia. So 4 cracking games that I hope that you'll stay and watch and savour all the way through. My name's Scott Hastings, your match commentator, and alongside me, one of the, not that person anyway, thankfully far slimmer, in the shape of Maggie Alfonsi.
I think I've got that costume at home though. Yeah, look, this is going to be a good game, Fiji versus Spain. Fiji without key player Nagasal, sustained an injury in the last game. But for Spain, their focus as well, similar to what we saw with Russia and Ireland, repertoire in June, that's going to be key for them. So they're going to want to finish this game on a high to ensure they take that into the repertoire. But Fiji, I'm looking forward to seeing key players like Salatala at number 1, debutant, who's been very good this weekend.
Yeah, she has been outstanding, hasn't she? And great support here in the stadium. The French have really embraced it, and behind the scenes we've got a sort of fan zone that has been rocking all afternoon. And Fiji have been very much popular players here in Clermont. So Elizabeth Martinez there to the right of your picture, the skipper for Spain, wearing the traditional red jerseys, and Fiji that distinctive white jersey. As Ana Maria Romita leads the team out. The ball picked up there by Luisa Tesolo. She has got real pace. Tesolo scored 3 tries already this weekend. This is their final game. The prayers are said. No, it's a nice little touch, isn't it?
Vale, y las que vendrán. Vamos a competir y vamos a darlo todo en este partido. Juntas. Sí. Tres, dos, uno, ganas!
Ah, brilliant unity. There's still passion there in that Spanish huddle. Our referee in the middle, Marie Lamette of France. Her fourth match. And she's enjoyed her weekend here in Clermont-Ferrand. There's Kuma. We identified her as a strike runner for this Fiji team. Spain, I must say, have also been much improved, but also they've yet to score a point on day two. Rebecca Tavo looks on. She's had a great tournament, Tavo. Had a real influence within the success of this Fijian team. Unlucky to lose their semi-final by 12 points to 14 over the USA. So here's Tavo. Ball picked up there by Mariama Nambosali. Oh, lovely play by Tesolo. Tesolo weaving, ducking up to the 22-meter line, inside out. Great support from the crowd. But Berta Garcia, wearing the gold scrum cap there, wearing that number one jersey, was back to save the day.
Oh, look at Tesolo go. We said at the start she's going to be an influential player in this game, and she does that in, out. Patricia doesn't know where to take her, really, but no, great work there, but Spain, unfortunately, creating an error.
It's a knock-on, yeah.
Fiji have this opportunity now to capitalise on this scrum.
Just notice, actually, Ana Maria Rangnitha, she is actually on the bench at the moment. Fiji Abira with the kick upfield.
It's a forward pass, red. That's a corner. Yeah. You see?
Forward pass there, was it?
Forward.
Forward pass confirmed by referee Lamat.
Vale. Igual la mele está super bien. Vale. Bien bajitas.
Yeah, here it looks like it's almost gone an inch forward there, but good pick up by the referee.
Good pick up by our camera team as well. We've enjoyed bringing the pictures to you. All right, wonderful French crew. Merci beaucoup.
Back front.
Attacking scrum then. This is the back is Ruwait. Oh, lovely little step there for Tesolo. Made it look so easy and gets Fiji's opening score in this game.
All because Tesolo. The reason why they got that try, she made the initial break back at halfway a few phases ago. And just finished off a lovely bounce pass to her to pick up and go. Patricia Garcia comes in to make a tackle, but just not strong enough to stop her from getting over this try line.
This Fiji team have actually looked far fitter than when we've last seen them in Langford. In Atlanta, the American leg last month, they've been working hard under the tuition of Chris Cracknell and Matthew Dooley. Special mention also to Ilese Tanavula. Vula to the big fella back in Fiji, no doubt watching on. And this young lady has absolutely caught the eye in this tournament this weekend. Ball spilt, picked up by Patricia Garcia, the playmaker for Spain. As I mentioned in my opening notes there, she could slot into any team on the circuit. Rebecca Tavo. Tavo with the switch play with Riwai. Riwai stretching the legs. Oh, lovely little interplay there. Nambosali tries to get the pop away, places the ball back there to Riwai. Kumu switches play. She got the call from Tavo. And Kumu up the middle, this long striding forward. Kumu turning Casado inside out. And what a lovely try. A typical Fijian sevens try that we all enjoy.
Lovely work by Rebecca Tarvo initially to start off with, to commit players, to release the ball and give it to the player out wide, Kumo. Something we've seen from Fiji, they're just so patient with the ball. They don't panic, they're just composed, and that's what they do so well.
And they bring joy to so many people around the world. It's always amazing wherever you go. There's always Fijian supporters prepared to follow their team. Another look at this work by Tavo, one-handed, and released the long striding forward.
Yeah, great work. Just the power and determination to get through.
Absolutely right. Loose pass for Spain, though.
Back.
Comes back, but they'll... Echeverria, she's got a bit of gas, Barria. Stays big, cuts back. That's the halfway line just in front. Oh, Garcia was under a bit of pressure there. Fiji have got the opportunity to play the ball, so they've turned it over. Footballing skills. Bounces into the hands of Naomba Salih. Oh, that's
wait.
Interesting play, let's say, which just gives up possession. No need for that from Fiji. Another kick, half charge down though.
Advantage, no con.
Rocco Makamama getting the ball. Oh, the ball's out to Bartlett.
Okay, so
Berta Garcia.
No advantage.
Just getting a little bit scrappy now. I think you can see that they're trying to get good field possession by trying to kick it away, but there, Patricia Garcia just giving
11.
A forward pass.
11.
Trying to get the ball out wide.
11.
To Berta Garcia. Yeah,
well, they're not sisters.
Okay.
They're just good old teammates.
And four. Number four, red. Okay, good.
Well, interesting selection. Sorry, the substitution there from... Jose Antonio Barrio from Spain, making the switch with Maria Casado into the scrum half position.
No.
Started at centre, and she's been replaced by Marino Bravo. So tactical substitution here for Spain early in the game of sevens, but in the end of the first half.
Yeah, and a good substitution that. She come on, she straight away created a bit of an impact by cutting a line and giving the ball to Maria Bravo. She does so well just to cut that beautiful line, just to drag the Fijian player to give that space for Maria Bravo to run through.
All in the back of the scrum then. This is Tavo, midfield, ball in two hands. Just options for Tesolo. Tesolo has Tavo on the inside, but that ball went forward. But Fiji being allowed to play with plenty of space and width in their game.
Yeah, I think you see here, Spain are almost just backing off and giving Fiji space to run into. I'd expect to see there Spain engaging, making the tackle, not giving her space to run in.
Casado then will feed the set scrum. This is the last play of the first half.
What?
Marino Bravo. Well, it's a sloppy pass. This is Real as well. Bravo, Real. Echeverria, she almost cut back in too quickly. And Tavo absolutely read it. Turnover possession then for the Fijians.
Okay, no advantage.
No advantage played then. That will be the halftime whistle from Marie Lamant. And it's Fiji in a commanding position. Two tries to the good. They lead Spain 10 points to nil at halftime.
Substitutional change. Right, Joanna's on. Pele, I want you to go onto the wing. Lulu, you go to Boba. Okay. Set. Girls, when we got the ball, all right, that the cuts, the work ethic is brilliant. All right, but we must get tracking in behind. So if Lulu makes a break, we can't be over here. We've got to gravitate towards the ball and be in behind to look for the offload or to clear the breakdown. All right? In defence, our connection and our work is excellent, okay? Our energy is fantastic, all right? But I want to hear the Talanoa go up. We're too quiet, all right? Far too quiet. So Talanoa's got to go up, all right? And I want to see that work ethic. Joanna, you're fresh, okay? I want you to raise them, you to bring them up. Everyone else, Joanna will drag you up for this second half, all right? 7 minutes, girls, all right? That scoreboard's back to nil. We've got to work, we've got to kill them off, we've got to be ruthless, all right? Support each other in attack, connect in defence, get the energy up, and the Talanoa. Set?
Set.
On.
Sorry.
Fiji all set for the second half. The fans look on, and those were the words of Chris Cracknell, just imposing to Joanna Soto, our half-time substitution, how important it is for Fiji just to hold their structures. And Maggie Alfonsi, it's fascinating listening to Chris Cracknell there, inspiring his teammates.
Yeah, he mentioned Talanoa. From what I'm aware, I think it means raise the communication, raise the noise, and support each other.
Tremendous height on that restart given by Viniana Ruwai, but it's Spain who come away with the ball. Trisha Garcia, she called for an early ball.
Play on.
So here's the ball brought back down by Marina Bravo. Bravo, that's the 10-metre line. There's Maria Ribeira takes the ball there.
It's okay.
Now, opportunities here. Attacking, stepping is Urbina. Urbina up to that 10-yard line.
Not hurting.
Jose Antonio Barrio really, really rotating his squad. Well, Kumu's in trouble here.
Eight.
She didn't retire
Eight.
The full
Not
10 meters, so that will be a deliberate foul and 2 minutes in the sin bin. So power play
back
here for the Spanish team. Seven players against six.
Time on. Not at 10. Back.
Smart play there by Spain by going quick.
So Spain, what can they do to unlock this Fijian defence? Fiji, a player down, sniping down the side.
It's okay.
Spain it deep into the Fijian 22. Ball's at the back there for Bravo. Bravo just short. Bravo showing great strength there.
Okay.
Picking the ball up is Maria Ribeira. Ribeira to Casado. The long pass is good to Real. And Real is in at the corner. Spain are back in this game.
What a way to make that comeback. Very good play there by Spain. Being patient, getting the ball out wide. They know Fiji are down by a player. Vanessa Real spotting that space and getting out wide.
Maria Casado from wide out. The spiral was the wrong way, but it's given the Spanish team the hope and the belief.
Spain are just aware that when they're down a play, you need to get the ball out as fast as possible. Don't keep it in the contact area. Try and commit the Fijians and then push the ball out to the outside channels.
And difficult for Kumu to look on there. Trying to score in the first half for Fiji, and Spain once again come away with the ball. Casado, full of confidence, full of energy. Maria Ribeira with the pass, and here's the Patricia Garcia, and then Bravo mistimes her pass to that far side, and there was an opportunity missed for Spain to attack down that blind side.
Yeah, the frustration's there, sitting on the sideline, thinking I could be on making a difference.
Please back.
But well done
back
by Fiji, by their discipline in defence. Now going to come up to full complement with seven on.
Of course, rolling subs as well, and seeing Patricia Garcia, she was substituted. You'll remember at the sort of close to the end of the first half, was back on for the second half. So the influential playmaker for Spain, having been rested, will then give her all for the next three and a bit minutes. There she goes, down the corner she goes, This is wonderful play by the wee Spanish maestro.
Scott, you called it. Patricia Garcia came on and made a difference like she's done all series. And what an impact off the bench.
She's a good kicker of the rugby football as well. Watch this, the conversion to come from wide out. Can she nudge her team into a lead over Fiji? 3 minutes on the clock. Scores are tied at 10 apiece. It's a good effort, but just doesn't quite get there.
Oh, the quick thinking by Patricia Garcia to pick and go and see the space out wide. Oh, Kuma almost got her, but just not enough. Lovely strength by Patricia Garcia. The pocket rocket puts the team back in the game.
What a tremendous try that was, wasn't it? Everything to play for then, 10 apiece. 2.5 minutes on that clock. And here's Kumu. Well, she'll want to make amends. Didn't quite make the tackle in the corner there. Here, Ebony Satala in the wraparound plate. It was good from Riwai. Riwai just slips and loses possession.
No advantage.
But no advantage had been gained. So it'll be Spain's put in just inside their own half.
Again, it's getting a little bit scrappy. Both teams know that anything can change the game now. One little error.
Here's a back.
One little advantage. But Spain's scrum now, and we know how strong they are in the scrum.
Bang. Set.
All then fed by Patricia Garcia. Bravo with that pass, Casado. Cutting back is Echeverria, but the loose ball. Oh, it's given the possession to Fiji. And that was good press defence from this Fijian side.
Yeah, really good work by Fijian side there, especially coming from number four, Bokamara. Just being patient and forcing that error.
Standing behind the back of the scrum then is Vanessa Real. She'll set off for Fiji, but the ball will be put in. Sorry, for Fiji. My apologies, putting the ball in the scrum half.
Be careful.
Okumurama, okay. And then back into Riwai. Well, Tavo came short. Been a judge to come back. Now to Solo. Up to the halfway line. Spain making their tackles. Ball bounces up favourably into Joanna Soto. But Casado was in with a tackle and going away with the ball. Patricia Garcia. Ball on the white side channel now, taken by Bravo. But the knock-on by Spain will give one final possession to Fiji.
Yeah, Patricia Garcia made the break.
Okay.
But Fiji just did enough to get their hands in there.
Captain Red, Captain White.
Well, I thought there was going to be time for one last play, but this particular playoff can't finish on a draw, so we're going to go into sudden death extra time.
Okay, it's team manager.
The team managers will come on and make the call.
Team manager? No? Yeah, come on.
Should only be 1 minute for these two teams to play out the win.
You know, I've played in extra times and it's so hard because you've got to pick yourself up again.
Number? Can you make it? You choose number. Okay. No, it's face.
kickoff.
You kick? Which side do you want? You will sit there. So you kick? Okay, thank you.
It's been incidentally as that. Won the toss there. Let's listen in. José Antonio Barrio.
Yeah, I can imagine there. Chris Cracknell's probably saying to them, girls, be patient. Use your offloads. Think about your support. Run those angles off each other until you see those spaces, those gaps in the Spanish defence.
Okay, one, which is not dangerous. So I was
just about to say there that Keith Chapman, who's the manager of the Spanish side, he said to his team, you take the kickoff, but give Fiji the possession. Always intriguing. You always think that you gain the possession would be better. But the decision's been made. And it'll be Spain through Patricia Garcia that will kick towards Fiji.
Okay.
If I was Spain here, I'll kick short and retain the possession.
Little wiggle of the hips. The concentration is good. And the ball is high up there. Bounces off the top of the head of Marina Bravo. So, what can Fiji do? Do we see a Fiji special from deep? Kumu attacks down the middle. Tavo goes into clear bodies. That's Satala. Satala looks at options. Oh, that's a poor, poor pass by Satala. She thought about the kick, went for the pass. And suddenly, the ebb and flow of this tie goes towards Spain.
Yeah, so Tyler, not quite sure what to do. She looks up and, you know, Debutant, who has been good this weekend, but there crouch. Was indecisive. Just needs to make a decision, take the ball in.
Bang, set.
So Patricia Garcia, here she goes, Garcia. Spain flood that contact, desperate for the ball. There was a knock-on, was there, in there? But Fiji guilty of killing ball. Excitement on the Spanish bench.
Yeah, there, Fiji got their hand in. Okay. Referee said, right, get your hands away.
So here's an interesting one. The wind is billowing around here. Golden score, of course. Patricia Garcia opts to go for a kick-it goal. Well, the brave call from Patricia Garcia. She scored the try to even things up. Can she score the winning drop goal, penalty drop goal, to win this playoff, 7th, 8th playoff place? Yes, she can. She's absolutely nailed it. And look what it means to still win a game of sevens. That's what it means. And Patricia Garcia takes the applause of this bench group. And Fiji, well, they've brought so much to this series. They'll be pleased with what they've done. And they will head towards Rio full time then in the 17th playoff. Spain 13, Fiji 10.
Thank you.
And so we come to the plate final, the United States of America against France here in Clermont, the host nation taking on USA. Well, France played well against New Zealand in the Cup quarterfinal, and if they can replicate that performance here, they might just have too much for the United States, who've struggled to hit form, or certainly the form that we know that they can bring. Just listen to the reception for the home team as France take to the pitch. Led out by the captain, Fanny Orta. United States, Gillian Potter leads them out, and we are almost set to go. An interesting one for a few different reasons, and Carlton Anna's beside me, certainly the home crowd. They're right behind this French team. They'd love to give them something to celebrate, wouldn't they?
Oh, most definitely, and an opportunity to come away with some silverware here in Clermont-Ferrand for the home side for us, the plate final. Really looking forward to this one. I think the combination with Jade Lepesque and Fanny Horta, the captain, in the halves is going to be a huge influence on this game. Pretty surprised that Victoria Florian gets to start in front of Jessica Javelet, who was outstanding in the USA's last game.
Yeah, they've tended to use her as that impact sub, but the pace that she brings, you just wonder why she doesn't start more games. But obviously, Richie Walker feels that her explosive pace is more of an asset off the bench than it is in the starting team. Goulion rises high, and that one goes back, and Jade Lepesque keeps ball alive for Grassy Nose, tackled by Olive Kelcher.
High tackle.
Well, certainly didn't seem high from this angle. Well, the referee, and no doubt about it, Chloe Pell fires it out to Shannon Izar, carries it one-handed through the gap, and the tackle, Barry Valala missed out, which means that France have possession. Fanny Orta to Lepesque, who leaves this one off the ground for Grassino. Kelter in possession, trying to rip one off the deck there. Good work by Olive Kelter. And Johnson digs one off the back. Now, chance for Victoria Falayan. Falayan backs their pace. Falayan skips through the tackle of Marjorie Mayat. And Victoria Falayan will score the opener in this plate final.
Well, that's why she's getting the start on the wing, Victoria Falayan. But it all came down to the great turnover from Leila Olive Kelter at the breakdown. France had it under control. It's pretty messy from them. And this girl, wow, the nice line she hit at speed, got it right through their hole.
So Barry Valala with the conversion attempt, right footed, straight between the posts, 7 points to nil. The United States of America leading the host nation, France, and it's Victoria Falayan with the try.
You see there, she was out on the left-hand side, coming on the end, and this little swerve to beat a would-be defender. She's just too strong for an arm. And she claps on the pace.
Yeah, sorry.
So Kelter, as you say, huge work rate to influence that try. That one didn't go 10, so France will get possession. The whistle hadn't gone. But now Mayan decides to get on with it. Little show in the pass there. Orta to Shannon Izar. Crowd, every time France get the ball into space or on their feet, and they're letting them know. Well, there's a groan of disappointment as Goulion dropped that pass. It went backwards though, and there's a little show in the pass on the outside. It's good. Chloe Pell tackle into touch. Was it high?
It
was high. And the second one as well by the United States. Izar, they're queuing up on the outside. Surely Hans will do this now. Mayan, flat pass again on the outside. Grassino for the corner. Grassino for France. Grassino strikes back.
Well, this French team playing at speed, and that's what they need to do against this United States unit. They're a big side, so they're going from side to side to side, using the width, using their passing skills. They got back-to-back penalties on that far side of the field. The ill-discipline by the US really did cost them, but it needed to be finished, and this girl here left no doubt. Gracias, no.
Shannon Izar with a conversion attempt all the way in the corner. That one's going to go left and wide, so 7 points to five. Franceville training by two. All about the hands here. Flat passing, and Gracias, no, with too much pace for Johnson on the outside. Beautiful high hanging restart. Look at the height on that ball again. And France get possession and the advantage as well. That is textbook restart Chloe Pell, shot in his arm. Oh, the pest couldn't hold it. It went backwards as the referee, and Gratino is in again. The second try for Camille Gratino, and it's a thing of beauty.
Well, Marjorie Mayan is the one that got up and contested that ball, knocked it back, and gave this girl a brace in as many minutes. Camille Gratino, a nice in and away as well. Very pretty to watch. Very smooth across the ground. And what I like, as soon as she got the ball, she just went. Here it is here. There's a two on, none overlap. As soon as she picked this up, boom, she's gone the outside. No one could touch it.
Izar, not her best strike, which means 10 points to 7. France leading by 3. And the home crowd given plenty to cheer about. Here was the pass. We thought this might have gone forward. Referee says backwards, though. I think it was the right call. And Gratino steps off that right. And off she goes. Again, restart perfect. Mayan goes for it with Johnson, and it was a collision in the air there.
You can't play from the ground, release the ball.
Adrian Mayan is doing outstanding work from the kickoff. And
doctor, please.
Her competition with Catherine Johnson.
Time back on.
Really starting to influence this game. Johnson, though, she's toughest now. She'll get up. Look at these two athletes go to work. Ooh, she lands right on her back with Johnson, but she's up.
Yeah, she's okay to continue, which is the main thing. Quick tap from Kelly Griffin. Barry Villala looking to unleash the speedster outside. This is Durbin. Big hit goes in from Izar and from Gratino. I tell you, Gratino, number 8 in her back. She is phenomenal.
Watch her here. Just chest on chest. There's nothing wrong with that.
Brilliant tackle.
Just showing that she can get it done on both sides of the ball.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Got to be able to defend in this game. No room for passengers when you don't have the ball.
Point. Set. Don't annoy her.
Jade Lepesque with the feed. Fanny Orta to Shannon Izar. Decides to switch tack and come back to the support of her teammates. Or does she even need the support? Does she even need her teammates? She's going to try and beat Kelter. Not too many can. And she didn't on that occasion. Inside a minute to go in the end of the first half here. Here's Chloe Pell. Here's Fanny Orta, the captain. And on the outside, Goulion tackled at the knees. And France keep it alive. Ball there again. That one went forward.
Ball lost.
Oh, it's unfortunate for France. They're definitely on a roll on. They're just playing at a level that the United States can't hang with at the moment. Just the speed is watch, they get to the breakdown right there. Just unfortunately touch the leg. No!
Sorry. When the ball is out, yeah. Okay, okay. Crouch. Point. Set.
Paravalada. Trying to force her way through Jade Lepesque. There's no room, though. Good tackle by the French number 5, and they get the penalty. Quick tap and go. Is there another score for France before the break? Mayan, dummy from her first time. Looping pass. Hat-trick for Gratino, is it? Yes, it is! Third try is a charm for Camille Gratino. It is the Gratino show, and France are in control.
Well, Goulion is the one that made the mistake with the knock-on, and she makes up for it with the turnover at the breakdown. Outstanding work by the number 10 from France. Gives them the last opportunity in this half, and they were able to execute to a T. Gratino is becoming a weapon on the outside. Look at there. They know where the threat is. They just got to give it to her with a bit of space, and she is a finisher.
Once, twice, three times a finisher, and that conversion drifts to the right and wide.
I couldn't
hear that. There is the halftime whistle, but another example of how to take a try out wide on the wing. And Gratino, well, she's dragged France from being 7 points down to being 8 points in front. They lead this one. A cracker of a contest it is, too. USA 7, France 15 at the break.
C'est bon pour tout le monde, Shannon.
Du trophée pour l'équipe qui va remporter cette finale.
Approchez-vous. Bon,
pour que ce match nous appartienne définitivement, pour qu'il soit gagné brillamment, il faut, un, mettre des mains hautes, d'accord ? Mettez vos mains hautes, raccourcissez un tout petit peu la première passe, mais mettez vos mains hautes. Ensuite, quand c'est fait, il faut envoyer les ballons. Faites-vous envoyer les ballons. Shannon, tu peux l'envoyer là-bas. Shannon, tu peux l'envoyer ici. Envoyez les ballons, parlez-vous et envoyez vite quand c'est fait, d'accord ? Pensez bien au pivot 4. Juste une chose défensivement, et en particulier, si jamais on perd le ballon, interdit de s'éliminer au bord du ruck. Interdit de s'éliminer au bord du ruck. Et vous rappelez toutes de l'extérieur, en question la laisse serrer là-bas. D'accord ? Allez, 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 c'est bien, c'est...
French crowd in full voice here in Clermont. And why not? They've been gifted to quite a first half here in the plate final. And as things stand, France are looking pretty good. Lepesque restarts again, gives her team a chance to get up. Mayan leading the charge. It went backwards and a pick off the ground from Barry Villala. And then she knocks it on. So advantage again to the host nation. Shannon Izar looks for Grassino on the switch inside. This time there's enough cover in the form of Kelly Griffin to make the tackle, but there was an overlap out wide here. Fanny Orta, beautiful pass to Chloe Pell. And then Goulion, good cover to get across.
Outstanding cover from Kelter, I think. It is it on their far side of the field? Oh no.
Okay.
It was desperation, but the French team are keeping their width at the moment. That's
I think
the
it was
secret.
Durbin.
Yeah, Durbin. Look at this. One-on-one outstanding there. Catherine Johnson.
Catherine Johnson. Well, ball off the top for the United States to use. Kelly Griffin in the line out. That one, another knock-on. It's all going from bad to worse for the USA now. Grassino's got nobody on the outside of her, so she's going to have to take it into contact. There is Kelter trying to rip it on the ground. She's got her hand on it.
Yep. It's a rock. Don't put the hands in. Release it.
Quick tap and go! Jake Lepesque. Try is given.
She was playing that ball. You were still on the hands in.
USA not happy about it, but the try is going to stand, and it's Jake Lepesque.
Well, they're just playing too fast at the moment, the French team.
Her
first try this weekend, quite surprising because she's always been in and around the ball, but more of a facilitator. Jade Lepesque.
No problem either with the conversion. 22 points to 7. A French masterclass at the moment.
Just a quick reaction, wasn't it? They weren't ready. The USA, they've had to do a lot of tackling, a lot of tired legs. And there's the sight.
Yeah. Substitution, time is off. Wait.
So Victoria Verlaine comes off and Jessica Javelet into the fray.
Come back on.
Can she use her pace? You feel it's a mountain for the United States to climb with under 5 minutes left to go. A couple of tries that would put them within a point, so they need three scores. They need one quickly as well. Kelter does have Javelet outside her, slipped just before contact. Back on her feet though, and well wrestled to the ground by Fanny Orta. Javelet back to scrum half. Only as far as Griffin, Barry Villala. Thomas trying to go through. Thomas, now we know she is very quick. Still got a lot of work to do though, and a lot of the pitch to go with his fresh legs. Oh, who is it? Who is it? Who else but Grassino to make the cover tackle?
Run away once.
Thomas. Shannon Izar gets the pass away. Back to Thomas. And I can tell you that Thomas has hurt herself in the act of keeping that ball here. Chance for France, and Tremoulier, not the fastest on the pitch.
Yeah, thank you.
She's tackling the touch.
Yeah, she probably should have pulled out here. Here's Thomas to making the break, and as you see, caught from behind from Garcino. You can see right at the last, she saw her out the side of her eye.
There's a knock.
And the one-on-one, I think it was Barra by Lala.
Comes off.
Getting back for the US.
Yeah, I think Thomas has just hurt her ankle as she went to ground there. It doesn't look well. bit of discomfort there more than anything else. But as you say, that's the textbook tackle into touch. Yeah.
We need a setter.
Not sure if she's going to be able to continue. Kirsten Thomas. Only just onto the pitch, of course, as well. That can happen at times, and the body's just warming up and you take a tumble like that. You're not as loose as you might be. And the stretcher is on for her.
Yeah, unfortunately for the US, because she made a nice break up the middle of the park. Did Kristen Thomas needed a score off that, but just the will to get back. Grass, you know, there in the middle of the screen. Gee, she's been a terrier, this one.
Just making sure that there's no more damage done, and first thing to do is to get that boot off and free up the tension. This is how she did it. The tackle from Grassino, you can see there her right ankle. She just went over on it as the tackle went in.
This isn't good, Hugh. This
just
is
there.
Not good.
Oh, that is nasty.
Yeah, that's enough viewing of that. We can see what's happened. So we're just making sure she's okay. She's a tough kid, Kristen Thomas. So we should make sure it's secure and get her off.
Yeah.
Well, the US for mine, you just need to get their hands on the ball. They've had no possession whatsoever to play with. France is just dominating, especially at kickoff. I think that's the identification. They need to get in their pods and try and lift and get clean ball.
We've got 3.5 minutes to rescue this game. Home fans obviously want to things to keep going the way they have been, which is some brilliant tries from Grassino and from Jade Lepesque. Shannon Izar on the attack. Can't get past Kelter, look at that. Presence of mind, though, to recycle possession.
What Izar did when she went across the field like that, she opened up the right-hand side where the French team actually dropped back and created numbers.
Get your thoughts ahead of the final then. I mean, you've got Australia series champions against Canada. Canada have been playing well, but Australia, I'm sure, will want to finish with a bang. How do you think that one's going to go?
Yeah, that's the thing. I know they've got the series intact. That's off their mind. So now they can enjoy it. And that's the first aim when you come here. You want to win the actual tournament you're playing in. And, well, it's been a good one here in Clermont-Ferrand, no doubt about that. So they won't want to go all the way and get beaten, I'm sure, this Australian team. But as you said, the Canadians, they've been so good. They've been able to stick around. So it won't be easy for the Aussies.
Yeah, so difficult to beat. They have set the standard, really, haven't they, this season? And for good reason, as we watch Grassino. Score tries for fun here.
They've been so good, this French team. They've been able to give Grassino opportunities in space. He's been able to use her individual brilliance. You see here, this is the main example of it. She picks the ball up, there's a player going in, she changes pace and uses this swerve. She doesn't even get touched. That is a great winger's try. Anyone will be happy with that.
Leaves them for dead. Camille Grassino.
The good thing for me here is that when you've got a player such as Grassino, who's not the biggest player on the park, but she can still cause damage like that, whether she's got ball in hand or not. You don't have to be a big lady or a big player to be effective in this game of sevens.
Absolutely not. Well, you can see the strapping going on to Kristen Thomas, and you know, you just fear for her now. I mean, if that injury is as bad as it looked, with the Olympic Games coming up, of course, USA have qualified for Rio, and it would be a devastating blow to the squad and for her personally to miss out on the Olympics. We'll have to wait, obviously, until the extent of the injury is confirmed, but it just doesn't look good. And our sympathies and our thoughts are with Kristen Thomas at the moment.
Well, she's in some great care. That's the main thing we can give to her. And, well, just these girls on screen out playing in front of us, they're going to be Olympians pretty soon. That's going to be exciting time, isn't it?
Exciting time for the game as well, and a chance to showcase to the world the skill levels that we have been seeing over the, not just this season, the past few seasons, and the dedication, the fitness levels, the strength, the speed, the agility, everything that goes with playing the women's sevens at this standard. And for anyone that hasn't seen it,
I'm telling you, their eyes are going to be open to a brilliant game, a brilliant standard of sport. Vic Folayan there.
Yeah, and brilliant players like Folayan really are going to become superstars on the world stage. I've been very impressed with the tournament over the weekend. What about you, Hugh? I think Clermont has put on an outstanding...
You know what? It's the crowd buying into it as well. It's so important. The reception that they're giving Kristen Thomas here, the atmosphere that they provide. The players deserve nothing less. They put all the work in, Carl, and you know, to have empty stadium wouldn't do them any justice whatsoever.
100%.
And it's great to see so many young, perhaps future internationals here as well. They might be inspired by what they've seen this weekend. That's what it's all about. And our thoughts and sympathies, as I said, for Kristen Thomas. Hopefully, it's not as serious as it looks.
Point set.
And play continues. Kelter out to Javelet. Now a chance maybe to see this gas firsthand. She's run all the way across the pitch. And Lina Garin will match her, I can tell you. She is extremely quick, the French number 12. And look at that for turnover ball. She's only just on the pitch. Lina Garin, take a bow.
There she is there, Garin in jersey, number 12 on the wing. Great defence, and they're just flying up at the moment, aren't they? The French, they can smell blood in the water. No doubt about that. They are not giving the United States an inch.
Point set.
Barovalala. Javelet. Chip and chase from Javelet. Now it's, we're going to see exactly who's the quickest here, because Garin is after it. So it's Grassi. No! The bounce of the rugby ball denies Jessica Javelet.
Go away, stay, stay.
Just when you want it to do something, it does something completely different. And that's the game. It's our 11 on 11. Picked off the ground there for the United States by Carlisle and into touch.
Well, that's when you know it just isn't going to be your day. Javelet comes onto the field and makes an immediate impact. She does it on defence on this occasion, but going forward, she used the chip. It was the right option too, but it just bounced a little bit too much as soon as she started to get into her stride.
Christella Duff to throw. Up to the front. Thomas takes it. Just dropped in the contact, but it's a line out to the USA. They waste no time. Barovalala getting on with it here. Javelet again. Javelet against Garin, and was there obstruction from Shannon Azar? Back goes Garin, but she's been caught asleep.
No.
And the foot skills from both. Bit messy, and USA get the scrum, just over a minute to play.
Well, Javelet, you've got to keep going for the ball. Don't worry about the refs doing. She should have an opportunity to kick that again.
Yeah, play to the whistle, isn't that what they say?
Most definitely. She's looking for obstruction right there, taking her out, but she keeps going.
Point.
You can see the ball just goes to the right. It could have gone back to her.
Yeah. There's a mistake there, you have to say. Barovalala trying to shake off the tackle. She does shake off the tackle, and Barovalala is going to sprint underneath the post. A bit of a dive as well, just for good measure. Inside the last minute, it's probably too little too late.
Well, they're going to go again, Barovalala. Kick it over and restart. Just realise the importance of it. There's still time in this one.
14-22. They need two scores, and they've only got 30 seconds. They need possession now. And even at that, it might not be enough.
They're kicking into the wind, so it's going to hang up. But look at Barovalala just using her strength to get through the tackle.
Got a cracker coming up after this one. New Zealand against England should be a fascinating matchup. Lina Garin takes it, it went forward. Well, there's the hooter. Do we have time for one last play? Yes, we do.
Yes, scrum.
That's French ball, the Hugh, so I'm sure they'll just keep it steady and kick this ball out. Look at this turnover, just a knock on there as they come in to clean that out, unfortunately for the US.
Crouch. Gap. Point. Set.
Awkward, one of the back to deal with, and Kelter with the pressure there.
Rock!
Well,
advantage offside.
I have advantage as well for the penalty USA because France were offside. Here's Barovalala, Carlisle. drifting across the pitch. Javelet one-on-one with Garan. Little step back inside, and Javelet off she goes. Javelet sprints the legs for the corner. Jessica Javelet scores. That will be the last action, and USA, they left their performance too late. Jessica Javelet in the corner, but France are going to win the plate.
Jessica Javelet, I'm glad she got the last score and the last say in this game, because as soon as she's come on, it's changed the dynamic of this USA outfit. They know they've got the extreme pace on the outside, so they're stretching their defence. They know the threat that she poses, and she has been a menace with her chip and chase.
So conversion to come, but it's immaterial because the gap is three, and this one is only worth 2 points. Barra Valhalla into the wind. This would be a monster if she was to get it. Not a bad effort, I tell you. That wind is going to suck all the life out of it. Otherwise, it was good. And a smile from her. France are your plate champions in Clermont-Ferrand.
Thank you.
3 points the gap. And despite that late comeback by the United States, what about that player, though? Camille Grassino. Incredible performance by the little French terrier. She's been brilliant over the last 2 days and turned on the style here when she was needed.
Oh, she was definitely the difference maker in this plate final, no doubt about that. The treble, anytime you get a treble in the final, you know you've gone pretty well. But she got some great service from her forwards up front. Pau Mayan, Guillaume, brilliant. Snaffling the ball and Horta in combination with Lepesque, good too.
Well, Fanny Orta, the captain there, maybe that was just a bit of a rallying cry, because this is the last tournament before the Olympic Games, and France has the players and the ability to have a say in that medal table.
Oh, most definitely. Yeah, I think the thing for them now is to be able to get that consistency for 40 minutes over 2 days. That'll be the big work on for them, because as you said, when they do get it right, they can put a performance like this together and they can challenge anyone in the world.
Well, for the home fans that have stayed on, and there's plenty of them, they get to celebrate some silverware here in Clermont. As Fanny Orta leads her team up to collect. And Christella Duff, what about her as well? The oldest player in the squad, and she was brilliant at times today as well, particularly in that quarterfinal against New Zealand. When France needed leaders, she stood up and was counted. So France getting ready to accept the plate. Caroline Ladegnou had a fantastic tournament as well, worth the mention. But here we go, presentation time in front of the home stand. Fanny Orta, the captain, and France are your plate champions for 2016 here in Clermont. Well deserved. And the celebrations will continue. We have plenty more rugby to come, including that cracker, as I mentioned, New Zealand against England in a few minutes' time. And don't forget the cup final to come, Australia and Canada.
England versus New Zealand, the third, fourth playoff. And it's all changed for both these teams. England bring in Abby Brown and Heather Fisher for their starts. Changes also on the wing with Natasha Brennan for New Zealand. Taruna Tamaki comes in at hooker. But watch out for Portia Woman and Kayla McAllister. Between them, they are a strike couple. 198 tries that they have scored on the Sevens World Series. Well, a good atmosphere here in Clermont-Ferrand at the Stade Gabriel Montpellier. The French support has been good. Well, I'm your match commentator, along Scott Hastings, alongside me, Carl Tanana. And Carl, I'm sure both these teams will be wanting to play for the main cup final. They met, actually, in Langford in the final that time. England came away beating New Zealand by 31 points to 14, but this will be keenly contested as well.
Almost definitely. In their final, you speak about as the French team go around and applaud their home crowd. The New Zealand team, I know for a fact, it'll be stinging for them, so they'll want some revenge. And, well, England, with their recent success, they'll have a whole host of confidence going into this one.
So Sarah Goss there, the New Zealand captain. And for England, it'll be Katie McLean who will lead out her team. An injury earlier on to Emily Scott hands the captaincy to Katie McLean. And as a Scotsman, I'd always say McLean, but I had a wee chat with her. And just to keep her mother happy, we'll keep it McLean. So wearing the clean strips are England there, their final words.
Is that you do
real attacking threat in Claire Allen and Emily Scott. Apologies for
anything today.
Bad language coming across there.
Believe, girls, we can fucking do this. On three, England. One, two, three.
England! Well, a real determination there, as I said. Apologies for any language you picked up. And I look there, Juliana Manuel there, and well, the try scoring sensation, which is Portia Woodman.
White, we're good. Black. Yep.
So Caleb Brazier will kick off in this third, fourth playoff in the Clermont Ferrand. Brazier. Now McAllister. McAllister steps inside, looking sharp.
Rack now!
Ball retained then by Tutamaki. And here's Sarah Goss. Goss down that side, cuts an angle. Brown, Fisher makes the tackle. Manuel had looked round there. Tackle by Natasha Hunt for England.
She's the tackler.
And Natasha Hunt, being the tackler, was allowed to play the ball.
Canarac's good.
Heather Fisher in there, what a terrier she is.
You got to go down to ground first. With a tackle assist, it's an entry, tackle assist.
So our referee in the middle, Rashan Mengi.
Well, I think already we're going to see how brutal the breakdown's going to be. See there, Sarah Goss. Thought that was tit for tat, but
it looked a wee bit like that, didn't it? And, well, the kick hasn't found touch, so Kelly Brazier will set off. Teresa Fitzpatrick, who really had a strong showing over in Atlanta and in Langford, direct running in this team, really made her mark in this New Zealand team. So Brazier to Tamaki. Goss calls for the inside line. Manuel, captain New Zealand to Rugby World Cup glory in the Sevens in Moscow. McAllister. McAllister goes on the outside, and Claire Allen couldn't match the pace for McAllister.
Well, their trial was actually set up with the decoy run from Teresa Fitzpatrick off Kayla McAllister. It held the defence, and when it did, Kayla McAllister realised that she put down the clappers. Watch it when she receives the ball. Kayla looks on the outside, a little dummy, and it just got Claire Allen a little bit flat-footed, and that's all that Kayla McAllister needed.
The conversion is good from Kelly Brazier, and New Zealand are into a 7-0 lead.
See the way they're just spreading the ball. Little stutter step, the little hesitation in defence, and Kayla McAllister is too good for that.
Yeah, Claire Allen clutching thin air there. An 81st try for Kayla McAllister in her Sevens World Series career. Hanging kick taken by Brown. to Tamaki. Right up with a tackle.
Now, ball's available.
McLean in the fly half position. She opts to go, but the tackle is good from Fitzpatrick. Fisher, who you remember, scored a wonderful try in the final against New Zealand in Langford. McLean to Brown. Goss covers the channel, and then the tackle has to be made by Brazier next up. So Natasha Hunt to Claire Allen. Allen straightens. McAllister comes across to meet the tackle. Show of the ball by Emily Scott on that far outside channel. And superb tackle by Portia Woodman. We've talked an awful lot about her attacking threat with ball in hand, but her defence has been excellent this weekend.
You see, she uses the outside, doesn't she, as an extra defender. She always knew she had to match for speed, and that's an easy concession of possession there, taking her over the sideline.
Open.
Kelly Brazier. But the ball snatched by Abby Brown, the tall English forward.
Ball's
available. Good refereeing there by Rasta Rashenbengi. Natasha Hunt. Oh, Natasha Hunt went in. Emily Scott went in to support, but holding on. And Sarah Goss, the New Zealand skipper, comes away with the ball. Ever present in this New Zealand team. Woodman. Oh, Woodman just goes on the outside. That is pure class for Portia Woodman. Her 10th try this weekend.
Oh, as an ex-winger, this is just a joy to watch. I love it when wingers just smoke other wingers on the outside. Portia Woodman. I can't help but smile because she's the one that created the turnover with her defense. There was nothing doing on offense, but she backed herself and out gas.
Niall Williams with the encouragement outside. Brazier with the conversion. And New Zealand have started strongly, haven't they?
Look at her here, Portia Woodman. This is sublime play. Number 11 on her back, playing on the right wing. Oh, yeah, beautiful.
I wonder if she'll match the number of tries to the number on her back. 10 tries this weekend, 24 this season. The top try scorer on the HSBC World Rugby Women's Sevens. And what about this? 119 tries in her career. She creates history every time she scores.
McLean,
Scott. What can Claire Allen do? McAllister will have her covered. There's real pace on the outside flanks for New Zealand.
Vantage.
McLean straightens. England. Well, they've not been in New Zealand's half, have they? It's been all New Zealand.
Yeah, they've had territorial dominance, haven't they, in this first 6 minutes of this game. England need a score next. You have to just feel here, Scotty, as we're coming down to the last seconds.
So the ball started by Emily Scott. Scott switch play to Allen. Getting caught up in the midfield is Natasha Hunt, but look at the pressure England are on as Fisher comes away with the ball. Now Fisher has a bit of gas. Kelly Brazier will come back, but Fisher stops and tackled by Kelly Brazier. Abby Brown then into the contact.
Release now!
Brazier just closed down the threat there from the English attack. Claire Allen. Manuel comes up in midfield, so McLean has to attack. On that far side, she invited the pass on the far outside. Tash Brennan, Brennan for the corner. Natasha Brennan gets one back for England. Brilliant try from England to bring them back into this game.
What I like about this play is they look for the weakness in the New Zealand defence. Kayla McAllister got caught on the outside, her legs were gone, and England exploited it. What a timely score just before the half. See there, Kayla McAllister goes in for the first one. That's where the hole was. You can see there's no way she could get back. No inside help for New Zealand. Brazier couldn't get there. Great score.
Good footwork, Carl Tanana, wasn't it? McLean just misses on that right-hand side. So it's New Zealand that will go in. Another wee look at this try then. New Zealand going at half-time. The lead 12 points to 5 as the last dapples of sunshine late in this mayday.
That's a one change.
Come across the ground.
So aim's on for Katie. You're going back on. Just suck it up. All right. Look, again, nothing to say indeed, because all they've done is thrive off the mistakes that we've made. Okay, so let's let that go. Two things. First of all, okay, we've got to speed the rucks up a little bit. All right. Depth at first. All right, and back the pass, okay? Because they're doing exactly what we said they'd do, all right? And if we just back the pass, or if they shoot, we can play over them like we just did then, all right? And then it's just a case, we just got to get a bit more urgency to the contact area. So if anybody's in any doubt, just hit it, smash it, recycle, chip. But the speed of the ball away from the ruck will be everything. If we speed the rucks up, don't let them reload, we'll get them. Opportunities will come, all right? But we have to look after the pearl when we've got it, yeah? It's simple. It's as simple as that. Possession, we get lion's share of possession, we speed the rucks up, okay, we'll get what we want. Right, the energy's great, the attitude's absolutely fantastic. All right, don't leave it at that. Let's go get the result.
Bit of
yeah?
Belief, yeah? Bit of belief.
Let's go. Once again, apologies for the use of language and words, but well, the supporters have enjoyed this one, I'm sure, right? In the New Zealand huddle, I think Sean Horan will have put out some clear instructions to his team. Deny England the possession, you can win the game.
I think at the moment, New Zealand sometimes getting caught over chasing. That's what happened in that last try for England. So just going to keep your space, back your defence.
Emily Scott for England then kicks off in this second half. The third, fourth playoff game. The penultimate game here. I think Clément Ferrand.
Play on, play on.
Manuel to Fitzpatrick, McAllister, the threat of Woodman on the outside. Here's Woodman dancing to McAllister. That old 1-2 combo working well for this New Zealand Sevens team.
Racknow!
It's been a long old season. This is the fifth tournament on the Sevens World Series. Loose pass there to Tamaki. Invites the tackle of Abby Brown. Brown did well. She was allowed to play the ball, but Goss making a nuisance of herself as well. Fitzpatrick, wide pass, bounces to McAllister. Woodman's on the inside arc. Woodman gets the ball there. Oh, it just came off her hand and spilt. Super tackle, though. Came in from Emily Scott for England, though.
Needed to be desperate defensive. McAllister, a hand away from breaking this tackle. Fakes to go inside the Porsche, uses her footwork. She comes back to her credit. Just a little knock on, unfortunately, the transfer.
Here we go, here we go.
Now, depth at first five is what Simon Middleton asked for, both from set piece and ruck. So see what England can produce here.
Okay, Squin, steady, please. Crouch.
So right in front of our commentary box, the scrum goes down. We've got a bird's eye view
steady
here.
Steady now.
Make sure it's straight. In it goes, Natasha Hunt. Claire Allen in midfield. Oh, thumping tackle from Portia Woodman. She closed down the space on Natasha Brennan. Wilson Hardy looping around there on the outside is Natasha Hunt. She has got pace and space. Wilson Hardy was in there, but Fitzpatrick intercepted for New Zealand.
Move white.
Woodman's been injured in that previous contact and collision. So New Zealand down to six players at this moment in time. Brazier, McAllister just probes. Look at the hard yards she got there.
No!
Well, England came in. Brazier, sharp, starts to attack. Claire Allen bundled into the turf. And Kelly Brazier, she'll back herself. Kelly Brazier, brilliant awareness from the New Zealand playmaker.
Well, she was like a puppeteer. Kelly Brazier as Ruby Tui is about to come on for Portia Woodman. The way she was playing with the England defence, you can't turn your back against a stepper like Kelly Brazier. Otherwise, she will rip you to shreds. Good awareness from the number 8 from New Zealand. Good urgency from the tap kick, even though they're one player down.
Yeah, the 26-year-old from the Bay of Plenty. She's been ever present in this team over the weekend and Can she get the conversion? No, she can't. And there's Portia Woodman. Well, she took a big clout in that tackle. But Brazier, just pure skill.
Look at it. Just eye up to the fence. Just lull them into a sense of security. You see that you turn your back and you can't do that. Emily Scott for England. She was on the back foot.
Brazier with the restart. Ruby Tui on for Portia Woodman. Now, Katie McLean, what is England's answer? Emily Scott has a wee goal. Superb tackle. Came in there from Teresa Fitzpatrick. Really putting her body on the line, Fitzpatrick. Into the action.
You went straight down on the play on the deck. The player was on the floor. You went straight down on the play.
England then to Brown. They've closed down that outside channel well, haven't they, New Zealand? Goss on this occasion coming up to make the tackle.
Moore was formed first before she touched the knee on the deck. Moore was formed first. Scrum.
Well, there must have been a second England player in there to form them all there, Carl.
Yeah, technicality. They're taking it right there. And then she tries to pull out late, so he can't do that. Once that English player comes to support her, it becomes a Moore. New Zealand don't have to release. See, one-on-one, Portia Woodman. Yeah. This is where she got the hit to the head, but Natasha Brennan stayed strong. Great contact, both players.
Okay, Crouch.
Manuel and Titumaki goes off. Now Williams is on and Otto Simpkins.
Okay, Crouch.
Shakira Baker also in this near side of the scrum on for New Zealand, so multiple changes, everyone getting a run. Ruby Tui to the wing.
Play on.
Waterman with a perler of a turnover there. Ball was at the back of the scrum. And Daniel Waterman turned over ball. And well, England,
they've
got to score twice to see if they can overhaul this New Zealand lead. Here's Waterman. She had good pace. Claire Allen comes down with the ball over the halfway line.
No.
Katie McLean goes in. Well, Goss did well, didn't she? She just got on the wrong side to deny England quick possession. As Waterman comes down this blind side.
Rack now!
Claire Allen under pressure there from Ruby Tui, winning that number
Release
one jersey.
Now.
Look
Rack.
At Tui.
Last feet there, please.
Slows the ball down. McLean to Brown again. Another example of the space being closed down. Brown makes the hit. Wilson Hardy is up. But New Zealand have got numbers there. Another break up the midfield by Natasha Brennan. England trying to throw everything at this New Zealand defence. But New Zealand have got numbers up. Richardson goes back down that blind side. Brown, can she pick it up? Well, it was forward. That was England's chance.
Oh, there must have been millimetres on this bounce.
Time off.
It's just in front of us. We couldn't see it from our angle, Scotty, but geez. Here it is here.
One. Yeah, scrum.
Oh, geez. Buster was right in line, to be fair, but I thought they looked okay. Hard done by Abby Brown.
I'm sure we'll have a wee chat with Rasta Rashinvengi about that one, Carl.
There we go.
Kay Wilson comes on. Sean Horan. He's always said that.
Okay, time back on.
He thinks this season is all about Rio.
Bind.
They've contributed
the
New Zealand team. It's Australia who've won the Sevens World Series.
Let's go, scrum.
But these players have given their all, including Kay Wilson there.
I want to see New Zealand give the ball to Renee Whitcliffe on the right-hand side. She's got very nice footwork. She has a touch player. Kelly Brazier right behind the scrum options both ways.
Brazier comes to this open side. Now a one-on-one here. As cutting back against the green is Renee Whitcliffe. Goss, that diving pass. Shakira Baker up to that halfway line. Tackled by McLean. This will be the last play of the game as Goss takes it up deep into the England territory. Williams to Brazier. It's been a good display from this New Zealand team. Otto Simpkins just the little hitch kick there. England trying to work so hard. Brazier, the little kick. We saw this a lot on day one. And look at the bounce is good for Ruby Tui. And Tui will polish off a polished performance for this New Zealand team. They'll get the third place here in Clermont-Ferrand. Ruby Tui.
Well, she plays her trade in the forward with Portia Woodman going off. She's gone to the wing as the power. The core come in. She put her little left hand up. Kelly Brazier, not for the first time this weekend, executing little grub in behind. Great composure by Rui, and that's the exclamation mark on a great performance by New Zealand.
And that winning performance here in the third place will secure a runners-up place in the HSBC Women's Seven Series title with the last play to come, the conversion from Vata Simpkins. It's not over, but the game has been well won by this New Zealand team. Final score, New Zealand 22, England 5.
Stage is set, we have our finalists and we are ready to decide the destination of the Clermont title for 2016. It's Canada against Australia. Australia leading 10-4 in the head-to-head series. And they last met, of course, in Atlanta in the Cup semi-final for Australia. We're comfortable winners. Here are the starting sevens for each team. Malesky, Paquin, Russell, Ben, Landry, Harvey and Lucan for Canada. Polite, Dalton, Turner, Tony Gatto, Kaslik, Quirk and Sherry. Surprisingly, no Shannon Parry in the starting seven for Australia. That's what they're playing for. Australia, three-time winners on the series already this season. Up against Canada, who have yet to claim the cup despite making the final in Sao Paulo, where they lost in the heavy rain in South America to their opponents here tonight, Australia. The sun has finally decided to come out. And we will have 10 minutes each half to decide the destination of the cup for this year here in Clermont. Both sides lining up for the national anthems. Let's hope we get a final fitting of what has been a brilliant weekend of sevens rugby. Canada first up.
Thank you.
Great stuff. Almost set to go here. Last minute instructions from the captain, Shannon Parry, who will not be on the pitch in the starting seven. Equally, no Elia Green, which is a surprise, I have to say.
First 10 minutes, girls, let's line up, right?
Yeah,
let's go.
Let's go.
One, two, three,
Aussie!
So the best two teams over the last 2 days ready to wage war. You could not call this one.
You could not at all. Both teams have put a huge effort in this weekend, and just seeing the emotions in their faces during the anthems makes you realise just how much both teams really want this.
That's the voice of Maggie Alfonsi beside me, former England international. We are
left to right.
Ready to go. Referee for this one from España. Alhambra,
yep.
Nieva.
Captain Red.
And
yep.
It's a perfect evening here in the south of France for rugby. We didn't have the sunshine that we expected today, but that doesn't matter. We've got 20 minutes to decide the destination of the cup and the last tournament in the series for this season. Olympic Games still to come in August, but right now,
we are released.
These two teams don't care about Olympic gold. It's all about winning this game. And Brittany Benn tries to launch an attack. Harvey, nice hands on the outside to Kelly Russell there. Keep that alive. Good to see Brittany Benn in the starting seven, despite the injury she picked up at the end of the last game. She's all stitched up and ready for action here as Canada through Kayla Maleski over that halfway line. And powerful legs pump her towards the 10-metre line. Landry, what a semi-final Ghislaine Landry had. Russell tackled and tackled hard. Brittany Benn in to help out. The ball caught up in one of the Canadian players' legs, but it's come back on the right side for them. Shuffled on there by Lucan and back to Maleski. Tackle goes in from Australian number six, Polite. Russell once more. Brittany Benn. Landry has Magali Harvey outside. Now we know Harvey has plenty of pace. She steps back in. Turner just let her go. And then gets the penalty. Good work at the breakdown there, especially by Chloe Dalton.
Yeah, fantastic work there. Chloe Dalton just does enough just to come in as Brittany Benn goes down, gets her arms in. Great strength there by Chloe Dalton to retain the possession there and get the turnover.
Play on, please.
Brittany Benn, as you can see, with the bandage over her cheekbone. Taken there by Alicia Quirk. Back to Cherry. Little show from her. And Quirk just took her eye off the ball. It was a lack of communication there. Russell, Harvey trying to go past Tony Gatto. Advantage being played to Canada. There for Benn, acting as scrum half to Landry. Lucan. A little bit static in the midfield. Maleski, oh, dangerous one. Almost intercepted as well, but kept alive. And Paquin. Awkward one. Came forward. Off a gold jersey, so it's going to be advantage to Canada. Landry, flat pass to Megan Lucan. Lucan trying to kick clear at the 22. Step in a roll, needs support. Delayed the pass and still on her feet. Now needs help. Karen Paquin, Ghislaine Landry. Nice pass to Benn, two outsider. Brittany Benn, if the hands get it, Russell to Harvey. Surely it must be. Canada in for the first try in the game.
Harvey, what a try! Great way to start the final there. Magdalena Harvey going over. All came from Brittany Benn.
Please move.
She does well, move, take the ball on, commit two players.
Please move. Move.
And the fantastic hands of Kelly Russell there to give that accurate pass just to put Harvey into space and over the gain line there.
Landry to add the extra two. Lovely relaxed smile. 7 points to nil. Canada have started perfectly. And the first try.
Just see here, Brittany Benn just does enough just to commit. Emma Tonagato, just that time, just to hold the ball up, gives Kelly Russell an opportunity to give that ball out.
Well, Harvey, absent for the last couple of tournaments, particularly in Langford, she was there as a spectator only, nursing an injury at the time, and she is back with a bang this weekend. And again, another player that's going to be so valuable in Rio. That one went forward. It's all going the way of Canada at the moment as Brittany Benn looks to create space on the outside. Kastnick put her down. Russell, Maleski, straight into Tony Gatto. still on her feet. Look at that for power in the legs. And the pass to Russell. Brilliant offload. Landry to clear out. Maleski back on her feet and in to try and act a scrum half. Pressure from Cherry and Australia, who cannot get their hands on the ball at the moment. Russell, show from her. She's a big unit and she can't be brought down. Kelly Russell underneath the post. Ferrella claps on the side, and well she might, because that was power personified.
Physical strength, physical power. Get out of my way now and stopping me from scoring. Great effort there by Kelly Russell.
Landry right in front of the post, and you back her to get this one every single time. Add the extra two. 14 points to nil. Australia have not been in this game, Maggie.
No, it's been all Canada all the way. What I love about the way Canada are playing at the moment is they're just being very direct. Here, Kelly just looks to give the pass and then thinks, no, I'm taking this on. Great determination, great commitment to the play. She just pushes off Kaslik and gets a try of her own.
5 minutes to play in the end of the first half. Loads of time for Australia to come back in. We know they have the players equally on the bench as well. Tony Gatto trying to lead the charge up the middle. Kaslik takes it. Cherry, nice hands. Australia trying to go through on the air through. Brilliant run from Chloe Dalton. She's done it all herself. Hardly to give chase, but Dalton's going to get there. Well, I said don't write them off. And that's why, because that was an individual brilliance by Australia's number 8, Chloe Dalton, finished it off, her fourth try of the weekend.
And that's why Australia are series winners. They know how to pull it back when it's required. Great work by Chloe Dalton.
Conversion attempt straight over. 14 points to 7, all of a sudden the gap is only a single try. Look at this again, she had everything to do. Lovely step, and then around the outside of Ben and Landry.
Just came from some beautiful footwork, which catches Canada off guard.
11, Brett, 11.
Substitution, Bianca Ferrella comes in, and Magalie Harvey goes to the sideline. No Jen Kish, of course, if you're just joining us from the weekend. Picked up an injury and couldn't take part today. Canada have done pretty well so far without her. Dalton restarts. Paquin trying to release. Runners on the outside. Russell steps back in, keeps that ball alive. Paquin, who started the whole thing, takes the pass and then needs a bit of help. Luke and tackle scrum half to Brittany Benn. Now Landry's going to back herself on the outside. Just named Landry. Dalton against Landry. It's Landry who's going to touch down. Hat-trick the last time. Another one in the final. And Canada, perfect response to conceding, is to score. And that's exactly what they've done.
Landry, the superstar against England. And now in the final, showing what she's made of. Came for a lovely pass from Brittany Benn. Was just invited Landry into that space, and Polito just can't catch her.
Yeah, too much gas for Polito, and conversion attempt. Is that one going to get there? No, it's going to drop short from Kelly Russell. So 19 points to 7. Wow, catch your breath. We've had four tries already. What a final.
Yeah, this is getting better every time. But now, can Australia pull themselves back?
Time off, please.
To get themselves back into this game.
Come on.
Landry goes for distance this time and happy to give the ball to Australia. Kaslik is back there. Elliot Green is on the pitch as well, and so is Shannon Parry. So clearly, Tim Walsh feels that experienced heads are needed here, and Elliot Green is so powerful. Brings play to the 22-metre line. Parry, first touch for her. Kaslik to Cherry. Need a bit of magic from Emily Cherry. We know how much she's capable of with ball in hand. That time, too many Canadian defenders in her way. Now here is Elia Green trying to stretch the legs. Paquin goes after her and takes her down around the ankles. Brilliant technique. And that's the only way to stop Elia Green, is to take her low. parry.
Back, back.
Ball went backwards. Dalton.
Rack!
Cherry. Oh, look at that, the steal from Maleski. Take it out. Polita goes back and makes the tackle.
Rack!
Oh, that was incredible. Lucan to Russell. She might back herself here. The pass to Paquin. Oh, well, it was just like taking a bottle out of a baby's hand, wasn't it?
Oh, Maleski there. Great effort. Oh, but you just think there. They just got the ball out wide. The potential could have got over for a try there.
Be careful, okay? Offside.
Beautiful work there by Maleski. She literally picks the ball out of her pocket.
That was a cheeky one, wasn't it? Straight out of her hands. And the penalty to Canada, if they were to score here, it would be a long way back for Australia. You just wonder, even with the talent that they have, would it be a bridge too far? Brittany Benn has Landry outside her. Benn's going to go herself. The tackle has to go in from Parry. It's not first time or second time. And Brittany Benn uses her strength to crash over the line. And I just wonder, is that the winning of the game? It's a long way to go, but Australia looks shell-shocked at the moment.
Thank you.
Canada are all over this at the moment. And look at her there, Brittany Benn. It's been phenomenal this weekend. Showing the scars to prove of her effort. Big smile there.
So, conversion attempt. This will be the last act, I think. And was it touchdown? We might go to the referee, but conversion attempt from Landry looks good from here. Well, when it's going your way, why not? 26 points to 7. It's been one-way traffic for the most part. Australia with only one try in reply. It means the halftime score in the final is Canada 26, Australia 7. Don't want to miss the second half.
Right. 10 minutes is a long time in sevens. Okay, so we got this game will swing, but the whole game has been down here. Okay, because we haven't respected the ball and we haven't tackled around the legs. Okay, we know they're going to narrow up in defense. Okay, and really have a go at that ruck. We've got to get our first receive positioning and our 9 clearance right. Okay, and then we can play with some width. You see no sweeper, the outside people see it. Okay, but we're going in and our first 3 steps are slow. Okay, so we're getting tackled in middle half breaks and we're second there. We have to be first, all right? So our first 3 steps, okay, are dynamic and we are first there. Okay, we're at tack lower, then we're first receiver out and we push it wide and spread them, then the gaps will open up through the middle. Okay, and defense, okay, their legs are pumping because we're going.
Okay, lots to talk to. We might start trying to put kicks in behind because our blitz is contained them so well. So second pass, outside comes up only on the second pass, all right?
Yeah.
We're
working.
Keep calm.
Hey, ball in hand, patience. When we're on defense, we connect, we talk, and we stay fucking calm, okay? Yeah. Team on two, 1, 2,
team!
Well, apologies for any bad language there, but you can imagine the tensions are high, emotions are high. Canada, I don't think they themselves can scarcely believe how dominant they have been against the 3-time series champions for this season, Australia.
Left, right?
So Elliot Green, Shannon Parry back out, Tony Gatto's on the bench, and Cherry, Kaslik, Dalton, and I think Polite on that far side there.
Yeah.
Canada. Can they keep this going? That's the question. Long restart from Landry over the head. That seems to be the tactic. Force Australia back inside their own 22, apply the pressure, and try and capitalise on any turnover ball. Kaslik, can she get something going? Charlotte Kaslik. Looking for help running with 2 hands on the ball. If you're a youngster watching at home, that's exactly how you should run with a rugby ball with 2 hands. Elia Green, well, she tucks it under the left arm, but again, every time she's had the ball, she's been pounced on. Cherry as scrum half to Shannon Parry. Kaslik again, nice line from Parry and keeps it alive. Emily Cherry on the outside to Elia Green. Russell drifts across. Shannon Parry's got 2 outside her. And she's going to go herself. Shannon Parry through the gap. Good tackle by Bianca Ferrella. Quick ball needed. Cherry. Kaslik looks for the switch with Green. Elliot Green. Australia have one back. Elliot Green. That was beautiful. Sevens rugby for Australia.
Tim Walsh said at halftime, he wanted them to respect the ball, play with whip, and that's what they did there. Shannon Parry ran it forward. Great tackle there by Bianca Ferreira. But a lovely work by Kaslik to cut that line, to invite Elliot Green onto the ball. And great work there by Australia. Megan Lucan just couldn't get to her. Too much pace by Elliot Green.
Elliot Green
time
touches
off.
Down.
Time off. Six goals.
Such a dangerous
six.
Runner, a ball in hand. And 26 points to 12 now. 14, two converted tries in it. Chloe Dalton getting ready to get us
time
back
on.
Underway. Over to that right-hand side. Decent take, Lucan to Brittany Benn. Ferreira. Oh, lovely hands. Lovely hands from Australia. Over the halfway line they go, and Paquin, the last pass, doesn't go to hand.
And yes.
Natasha Watchman-Roy is only just on the pitch, maybe a little bit cold coming in, but...
forward. Not bad.
Yeah, here, she just forces it too much, which goes behind Karen Paquin. And when you're on the
Use
wing
the
there, you want the ball to be in front of you so you can run onto it. Any opportunity to get that front
go,
foot
sir.
Ball... You want to use it. There, just went right. Behind her.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Kaslik to feed. Awkward one. Slow to come back out. Eventually it does, though. And Quirk, little grubber kick through. Cherry's after it. Ferreira is back there. Has a bit of time now. And her teammates all come to support her. Lovely run by Ferreira. Good tackle by Cherry.
Rock!
And she got away there. Could have been danger for Australia. Tackle goes in on Watchman Roy. Lucano sized up by Elliot Green. Brittany Benn took a thumping tackle there. Oh, what a monster hit that was. That could be the catalyst for something for Australia here.
Yeah, this could be the changing moment. Look at her, come in, Bosch. Go. You do not want to get in the way of that. Elliot Green.
Thanks, Bob.
The green machine.
What a tackle that was.
Please. Time on.
Just under 7 minutes to go here
Crouch.
In the final. Lucan comes off.
Fine. Set.
Australia with a scrum. Kaslik defeat. Quirk. Drifting across the pitch. Cherry. Switch with Green. Wants to keep that ball alive. She hits the ground.
Tackle only.
Kaslik. Parry. Switches direction. Back to Cherry. One outsider now. She'd given that. Green was unmarked here.
Tackle
on the wing.
Eight.
On this near side. Kaslik now spots a 2-on-1 overlap. And Green. Brittany Benn stumbled at a crucial stage. Oh, but she got across to make the tackle. Kaslik for the line.
He's out.
The flag is up. It's touch. It's not going to count.
Red ball.
Oh, great effort by Brittany Benn. Just to save that try there.
What a tackle.
With her long arms there, gets a nice tackle on Ella Green's
time off.
Legs and just does enough to get her
time
into
off.
Touch.
Let me know, Bob, what happened. Yeah.
Try saver, no doubt about it.
Yeah, thank you.
Brittany Benn just been phenomenal this weekend. And her face, I mean, she has worked
Quick
so English. Hard.
Yeah, if not, she...
To see Elliot Green go, you think, she's going to be in. But Brittany Benn uses every ounce of energy in her legs to dive and make that tackle.
Let's just have a look at this one again. So Elliot Green stays in touch. The foot goes out there. She must have had possession still. That's a really good spot by the assistant referee.
Okay, yep.
Really good spot because her foot just touched the sideline and she still had possession.
If anything, Elliot Green's green boots gave it away.
Yeah, that's it. Too easy to spot those psychedelic boots. Ball's come back on the Australian side. Held up, is it?
Leave it
just
leave
short
it,
of the line. Chloe Dalton. Where's that ball?
No. You must release and leave it. Nine. No.
Landry's gone. Oh, this is a massive
Please.
Blow for Canada.
Wait.
She's been carded. No. Has to go to the sin bin, so they're down to six players temporarily.
Player.
And Australia with the penalty. Two converted tries in it at the moment. What a final this is turning out to be. Looping pass from Sharni Williams to put Cherry in the corner. And Australia have another one. Emily Cherry touches down. They make the extra player count. And this is game on.
Do not count Australia out. We know how dangerous they are as a team. They will make a comeback. But it all came from Canada making the error. Landry being carded.
Conversion is good as well. 26 points to 19. 7 the gap.
Beautiful work here for Emily Cherry. Wow, I mean, she's been another one who's been sensational
time
this
off,
weekend.
Time off. One. She's there. Time ball.
Well, you just wonder how much more damage can Australia do with the extra player advantage. Under 5 minutes to go. Tired bodies, I'm sure, on both teams.
Back.
High hanging restart. Good slap down, and Harvey is there to tidy up. Bit of support from Watcham Roy and get the penalty. And what do you do here? Do you try and eat up the time and go up the line, secure the line out?
It's gone 4 minutes now. What I would do, I'll go for the line out.
Yeah, well, it makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah.
With the player in the sin bin. Landry still off the pitch, don't forget. Down to six players, Canada. Harvey gets every inch out of that one. Good kick.
Yeah, great tackle there, but what happened here, she didn't get back onside. Wasn't the tackler's right. There's a ruck there.
Good spot by the referee again. Landry can only watch. She got 10 seconds left to wait. So she's going to have to grin and bear it for one more play. Packham goes up, takes it into contact, drives those legs, and pick off the back there from Canada. And this is Darling. Still there. Ferella trying to go through the middle, two to bring her down. Good strength advantage being played for offside. Harvey. Paquin. Darling with its more. Watch him, Roy. And Williams outside her. Chose not to use it though. Canada with possession, only six players, and comfortable defence at the moment for Australia. Harvey, can she get a bit of magic going? We know how quick she is. Tackled by Cherry and Green. Green back on her feet. And ferocious battling at the breakdown there now. Ferella spots the gap. Bianca Ferella has a runner outside. Paquin has to reach for that one. Karen Paquin almost got there. But I think she just stumbled as she took that pass. It was that tiny bit in front of her. Darling. Brilliant retention by Canada. Exactly what they would have wanted. Can they get a score to push them two in front? Oh, ball over the back. Williams, did that go forward? Penalty. Offside against Sharni Williams. Surely Canada must be back to seven. On comes Landry. Well, I think if they take this kick in front of the post, it'll mean that Australia have to score twice.
Yeah, will they be thinking that right now? She's a Landry's taking the ball forward.
Go for points!
You can hear on the sideline they're shouting, go for points!
Landry to make it a two-score lead. That's exactly what she does! Chislane Landry out from the sin bin and 3 points.
Chislane Landry, a very smart player. Knew what was required there. What are Australia going to do to get themselves back into this game?
It's a 10-point game. And they need something quickly, 90 seconds to go. Wow, what a final this has been, Maggie.
Oh, it's been absolutely brilliant. It's been all Canada. And there's Brittany Benn. She's been a huge part of Canada's performance.
Time on.
Yeah, she's been in the wars, hasn't she?
Play on, please, quickly.
Bravery personified, quickly. Brittany Benn. And Landry, possession for Australia. Crucial, too much on that one. Did it bounce before it went in? It did. So line out Australia.
It's always funny when after you score, there's always an error after.
Back then,
1 minute to go. Australia need to score, and they need to score now. Off this move, ball off the top. Kaslik to Toni Gatto. Toni Gatto switches to the right. Cherry, it'll show and go from her. And Cherry is going to back herself on the outside against Harvey, but she won't beat her for pace. Harvey is just too quick. If Australia don't score in the next 10 seconds, 10, 15 seconds even, you feel that Canada are going to win this one. A tackle in the middle from Paquin. Sharni Williams puts the head down. Sharni Williams still going, needs to be put into touch. Williams against Williams in Australia. That went forward, its flag is up on the far side. That should be that. Canada, have they done enough? I think they have.
Wow, pulsating stuff. Emily Cherry, but Christy. Fantastic, Chris Charity Williams does enough to just try and force her out. Canada have been phenomenal.
Phenomenal is the word. They really have surprised Australia. Yeah! It's gone out. That should be it. Canada are champions in Clermont. What a final we got. 29 points to 19. Packed full of tries, packed full of excitement. And the crowd at the stadium have been treated to an exhibition in women's sevens rugby. Brilliant.
Yes. It's been great rugby. Both teams put a performance in, but Canada, look at them there, embracing each other. They had a challenging tournament out at Langford. Didn't end the way they wanted to, but they saved the best till last. And what a way to end the series.
Well, I tell you what, as a marker, laid down ahead of Rio, the Olympic Games. That's quite something to finish the series with a tournament victory for Canada. They were close in Sao Paulo, but outplayed in the final. They turned the screw today and reversed that game and the result. And you can see what it means to them.
No one can fucking beat us. We fucking believe that. Team on two, one, two.
Team! Yeah!
And there's Landry, one of the star performers as well this weekend. Just a great team effort generally by Canada.
Really was. I mean, there's strength all over the pitch, forwards and backs combining, even the players coming in off the bench. You saw the impact that they made, particularly in the final as well in Australia. They can have no complaints today. They have been the best team over the course of the series, but they were not the best team in the final here in Clermont, and Canada deservedly will take the title.
And there's John Tate, big man with a big smile on his face, and he should be happy. What amazes me by Canada is that they always work hard for each other. Even though Jane Kish has been out injured, they've still pulled it together. They've lifted their game and ended on a high.
Yeah, ups and downs, but that was a great performance, ladies. Top to bottom, 11 players all across the board. Well done, you should be really proud.
Canada on two, one, two.
Canada!
Yeah!
Spare a thought for Jen Kish, who misses out today. I mean, she would have loved to have been part of that. She deserves to be a part of it, but just not to be for her today, unfortunately.
No, Jen Kish has been part of the squad, has contributed to the success. And we just hope that she gets back in time for Rio.
Here, here, and I'm sure she will. Well, you can see what it means to Mark Tate and to the rest of the players, to Magali as well, who missed out the last couple of tournaments, the majority of this season, in fact, from a couple of different reasons, just struggling with injury as well.
Well, Gislin Landry, congratulations on the win. What about, or what is it about this Canadian team this weekend that just continued to fight for everything?
Yeah, you know, we've put in moments of brilliance all season, and for us it was about consistency. I think this tournament shows that we can do it for 14 minutes and in that final 20 minutes.
That first half, you really put them on the back foot, four tries, it really stung them.
Yeah, I mean, that's our plan going in any game, just to fucking...
It's okay.
To go out and to run hard and run hard lines, and we did that, and we've been doing that all year, so yeah, it's good.
All about emotions. Congratulations. You go and get that silverware. Well deserved.
Thank you very much.
Gislaine Landry. Well, maybe just the occasion getting the better over there. That's one for the bloopers reel, but You know, she has been phenomenal this weekend. Some of the tries that she has scored, Maggie, out of the top drawer.
Yeah, I mean, she has pace to burn, but also a very smart player and someone who leads the team when someone like Jen Kisser isn't available. She steps up and puts in a performance when you need her to. And she did that against England and did it today against Australia in the final.
So the player of the final, as you can see there, Alison Hughes, about to present Kelly Russell with her trophy. I think Ali's a little bit shy to be in the limelight. But yeah, Kelly Russell, she was instrumental in the first half in particular. She did the hard unseen work for this Canadian team that set the platform for victory.
Yeah, when we talk about good players, sometimes you don't always see the hard work they do, but someone like Kelly Russell fights those extra inches you don't see, gives those good passes, and just commits herself to every cause on the pitch.
You know,
well-deserved player.
The likes of Harvey will take the credit for finishing, and Landry too, but unless you have people like Kelly Russell who are prepared to put in that hard work, you're never going to get that ball in the first place.
Definitely, you need players like that on the pitch because they do all the hard work, the hard graft to lead to this success.
Well, here we go. It is success for Canada, and it's well-deserved success, and you could say it's been a long time coming this season. Canada champions in Clermont-Ferrand. They have been the best team. Some brilliant performances over the last 2 days, not least in the final against Australia, when they needed to turn up and bury the ghosts of what happened in Sao Paulo in the teaming rain. They've done that. And they are worthy champions in Clermont for 2016. Yeah, I'm sure they'll all enjoy the celebrations and a party tonight. This is how the series table looks after five tournaments. Australia champions, that was confirmed earlier on today. New Zealand have to settle for runners-up. And Canada, as you see, with the victory, tying England on 74 points, but they edge it in terms of points difference. So they will take third spot all the way down to Colombia. Player of the final is Kelly Russell. Russell and Alison Hughes presents her with her victory. HSBC player of the final, Kelly Russell, Canada's number four. Plenty of smiling faces as you'd expect, and the most important thing, I suppose, is to keep everybody fit and ready for the Olympic Games in Rio in August, where it'll be a battle for the gold medal. So many contenders now. You have Australia, don't write off New Zealand, Canada with a late show today. I mean, it's going to be a fascinating tournament.
I can't wait to Rio. It's going to be amazing. We've seen how talented these athletes are over the series, and I think we're going to be treated to some fantastic rugby out in Rio for the world to see just how good women's rugby really is.
So, Portia Woodman and the rest of her New Zealand teammates accepting silver for second place in the series. Portia Woodman, just an incredible talent. Kelly Brazier, again, so much hard work by her. New Zealand, you know, they'll go back and rebuild. They're used to being top dogs, and I'm sure it hurts to see them watch Australia take the series championship this year. But Fata Simpkins and Kayla McAllister, well, they'll be back at Rio, and you certainly wouldn't bet against them.
Yeah, Sean Horan said it's all about making sure you peak at the right time, and we're still a few months away from Rio, so anything can happen.
And this is where the coaches are in their crossroads, I suppose.
Yeah, this is the time when they've really got to try and get their players right, get them fit, and get them ready for what is going to be an amazing tournament.
Presentation of the medals. Fitzpatrick and Ruby Tui behind her. It's been an interesting series overall. Obviously, Ireland were the new addition after qualifying at the end of last season's campaign, and they came in, I think, a little bit of an eye-opener in terms of the standard that's expected at this level, but they will improve if they can hang on to a place for next season. Somehow hang on to a place that you'd imagine they will only get better.
Yeah, definitely. There's still a lot to go for Ireland, Spain and Russia. They've got their repechage in June, but it's been an exciting tournament this weekend. I think my particular highlights have to be Kenya beating Japan.
Yeah. Just goes to show you, in Kenya as well with some beautiful rugby. Bianca Ferreira with the cup for today, but they're going to have to give the limelight over to Australia now because they are the series champions. And it's been a long, hard road to get to this stage. Not easy to keep a side together, keep players fit, put in performances, tournament after tournament, five of them, three victories in total. Shannon Parry, such a huge part of that. Turner and Elia Green, well, what about her? The matchup, every time she and Portia Woodman take to the pitches, you know it's going to be explosive.
Yeah, Elia Green, Portia Woodman, the list goes on with some fantastic talent who have great wheels. But Australia, I feel for them, they've been the most consistent side this series, and it's hard to take the winner's medal of the series and not finish on a win out in Clermont.
Tony Gatto tries for fun this season for her. Emily Cherry, you don't often see her without the scrum cap. Penitani, Kaslik, Polite, Nicole Beck as well. And Chloe Dalton, the last of the players to receive the gold medal. Squad effort though, coaches, backroom staff, physios, they all deserve their moment in the sunshine because, you know, the players couldn't do it without the backroom staff, and that's important to say.
Most definitely. When you think about the medal around your neck, you have to think the player is the medal, but the band that holds the medal up, that's the staff, that's the admin people who do all the work for you to get you where you are today. And it's good to see them collect a medal at the end there.
Well deserved. All started back in December in Dubai. Australia set down the marker. We wondered could they keep it going. They answered emphatically yes. And culminates in this trophy for this season. The HSBC World Rugby Women's Seven Series Champions. Ladies and gentlemen, Australia! So, with that, we will leave you. It's been an incredible season. We're looking forward already to the start of next year. And we have a certain matter of an Olympic Games in between all that. But for now, we leave you with Canada as Clermont champions, Australia as the series champions. And it's been quite a journey to get to this stage. We hope you've enjoyed all the action here. We certainly have enjoyed bringing it to you. And we'll be back next season to do it all again. For now, thanks and good night.
Yes, sir.